The following is a presentation of WGN Sports.
In Chicago, WGN Sports is proud to present Chicago White Sox baseball. This afternoon, it's the Big Hurt Frank Thomas and the Chicago White Sox versus Kevin Gross and the Texas Rangers. And hi, everybody, and welcome to beautiful Comiskey Park. With Tom Pachorik, I'm Ken Harrelson, as we get set to bring you the first of this doubleheader right here with WGN. And it is a cold, dreary day here in Chicago. But the pitching matchups went Peru, Wilson Alvarez against Kevin Gross.
Right, and it is a perfect afternoon for baseball. Wilson Alvarez was great against Texas last year. He was 2-0 with an 0.60 earned run average, and the Sox really need a good pitching performance in this first game. Kevin Gross really struggling. He's pitched 20 innings on the season, has walked 20 already, really struggling with his control.
Well, the Sox coming in at that 8-14 mark. They are 2-4 on this 8-game homestand. Better get something going. So sit back, relax, strap it down. Game one of this doubleheader, and we'll be back with the rest of the starting lineups right after this.
Chicago White Sox baseball on WGN. Brought to you by Miller Lite. When you've got the great taste of an ice-cold Miller Lite, life is good. Your local Ford dealer. See 5 of the top 10 selling vehicles in America at your local Ford dealer. Coca-Cola. Always a hit. Always Coca-Cola. Aflac. Insuring over 38 million people worldwide. Menards, helping you build America's heartland. Your Chicagoland Northwest Indiana Toyota dealers. I love what you do for me, Toyota. Hoover, nobody gets the dirt like Hoover. AT&T, for the life of your business. And by Southwest Airlines at convenient Midway Airport, the official airline of WGN-TV Sports. Fly Southwest, the low-fare airline.
Good afternoon and welcome back to Comiskey Park in Chicago. The first of two games today between the Sox and the Texas Rangers. Sox have taken the field for game one. Wilson Alvarez on the mound. And here are the starting lineups. First of all, for Johnny Oates, Texas Rangers. They're one game over 500, tied for second in the AL West. Leading off in center field, this Nixon is a crook. Otis plays center field. Batting second at second base, Jeff Fry. Mickey Tettleton, the former Tiger, is the DH, batting third. Cleanup man, third baseman, Dean Palmer. Yvonne Rodriguez is behind the plate in the fifth spot, followed by the American League's leading hitter, Mark McLemore, in left. Jack Voigt, what an actor he is, at first base, bats fifth. Rusty Greer is in right in the eighth spot. And bringing up the rear at shortstop, the youngster, Benji Gill. Defensively, the Sox line up with Tim Raines in left field. Lance Johnson is in center. Mike Devereaux plays right. Robin Ventura at third, Ozzie Guillen at shortstop, Ray Durham at second, the Big Hurt Frank Thomas at first. DHing this afternoon is John Kruk, making his first start in a White Sox uniform. Mike LaValliere behind the plate and Wilson Alvarez on the mound for the good guys. Wilson 1-2 with a 3.27 ERA, has started 4 ball games, completed none, given up 25 hits in 22 innings, 11 walks, 14 strikeouts so far on the season. His last outing, the 17th, a no decision against the A's, giving up 6 hits in 5 innings, 2 earned runs. He walked 5 and struck out 6. The umpires are good friends in blue. Here they are, Jim Joyce at home, Vic Voltaggio at first base, Dale Ford at second. Crew chief Jim McKeon is at third. There's a look at John Kruk in the Sox dugout, DHing, hitting fourth. And now we're ready to go. Here's the Huckaroo.
All right, Wimpy, thank you. And once again, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to White Sox baseball from beautiful Comiskey Park right here over WGN. 36-year-old veteran Otis Nixon will lead it off. One of three switch hitters in this Texas lineup. Otis hitting at 279, no homers. He has knocked in 15. Alvarez pours the fastball over. And the count nothing and one.
These two clubs met nine times last year, with Texas winning five of the nine. Is that curveball? That's in the center field. Lance Johnson. That's a can of corn. And the lead man down. 347 down each line. 375s in the gaps. 400 straightaway center field. On a day that has rained hard all morning long. It is supposed to rain all day, but we do have a window, and hopefully we can get this ball game or both ball games in. That'll bring up the second baseman, Jeff Fry, hitting at 323. No homers. He's knocked in seven. He's faced Wilson five times in his career. He has two hits as Robin now comes in at the cut of the grass. Fry takes the strike. Outfield for the most part straight up. Bit of a gap in right center. So the Sox, as we mentioned, 2-4 on this eight-game homestand. That's not a too good. But in the last 22 games against the Rangers here at New Comiskey Park, Sox have won 16 of the 22. Change up off the plate, and the count moves to 2-1 with Mickey Tettleton on deck. Jammed him with a fastball, pops him up, Ventura. And that's out number two. Other American League action will show Minnesota at Detroit, Milwaukee at Cleveland. Kansas City takes on the Blue Jays at Sky Dome, Baltimore at Oakland, Boston at Seattle, and the Yankees against the Halos at the Big A in Anaheim. And we'll take a look at Tom Skilling's forecast that we just saw in the WGN News. There you see 52 degrees, wind northeast at 11, and showers.
Has Tom ever been wrong?
Not too often.
Never?
Not too often. Here's Mickey Tettleton. The DH hitting at 253. He does have six homers, and he has knocked in 17. 1-for-8 lifetime against Alvarez, and that one hit did not stay in the park.
It was a home run.
Yeah. Takes it down low in a count. 2-0. Over the National League, Cubs take on the Rockies later on. San Diego at Montreal, San Francisco at Philadelphia. The Astros against the Reds at Riverfront. Fighting Fish against the Buccos in Pittsburgh. Dodgers at New York, and Atlanta against the Cardinals in St. Louis. Shanks that pitch right side and a count. 2-2. As the skipper, Johnny Oates. Wimpy told you, Rangers 13-12. The game's back of California in the West. Sox in some trouble. 8-14, 7.5 games back of the Tribe. That's a good heater. Count evens at 2 to Tettleton. Outfield playing him the hook. Fastball up and away, and a full count with Dean Palmer. Not Brad, Dean Palmer on deck, Wimpy.
Right. Very good. You'll get him before the day's out.
No. You did last time.
I did? Wait a minute. That was last year.
This spring.
Oh, okay.
That's ball four. So Mickey Tettleton, who will take a walk. First base runner. And here comes Palmer. Dean hitting at 301. Five homers. He's knocked in 17. Dean has faced Wilson nine times in his career. He has three hits, all of which have stayed in the park.
No home runs.
As you can see, it's nippy, but there are some troopers. Fastball, ooh. Right there, didn't get it in the count, 1-0. Palmer, just 26 years old. Takes that curveball high. Wilson dropping down, getting underneath it. Dean Palmer's a cluster hitter. He hits them in clusters.
Yeah, he does.
When he gets high, I don't care who's out on that mound.
You're right.
That ball hits sharply back through the middle for a base hit. So Tettleton will hold at second. And with two out, Rangers have runners at first and second.
Dean Palmer, short and quick. Little inside-out action on that swing. Wilson trying to come inside with the fastball, but Palmer still able to get the barrel of the bat on him. But look at that head. Was almost completely still right there. Good swing, good contact. Base hit.
Here's the catcher, Yvonne Rodriguez. Hitting at 256, no homers. He's knocked in six. Lifetime against Wilson, he's 3 for 6, two of which stayed in the park.
One homer.
One and oh the count.
Mike Palmer really cutting down on that strikeout ratio, Hawk. He has 15 strikeouts, 15 walks, and 84 at bats now. He's usually a lot higher than that.
That pitch looped foul and out of play. Souvenir right side. And a nice catch by one of the fans who brought his glove to the park.
See how important that is? He doesn't make that play without that glove.
A ball, a strike, two out here in the top of the first if you just joined us. Tettleton at second and Palmer at first. Outfield playing Rodriguez straight up. Long set by Alvarez. Now gets a sign from Spanky. Here's a ground ball. Little three hopper. Ozzie up with it. Over to Big Frank, and that'll retire to the side. Nothing across. There was a hit, no errors. Two left after half inning of play. It's the Rangers nothing. And the good guys coming to bat.
No score, bottom of the first inning here at Comiskey Park. And here's Gene Lamont's starting lineup for game one. Leading off in center field, the one dog, Lance Johnson. Batting second in left, Rock, Tim Raines. The big hurt, Frank Thomas, plays first and bats third. John Kruk is the DH in the cleanup spot. Robin Ventura returns to third base. He'll bat fifth, followed by right fielder Mike Devereaux. Ray Durham has been playing great baseball at second base, hits in the seventh spot. Batting eighth behind the plate is Spanky LaValliere, and bringing up the rear at shortstop, Ozzie Guillen. Defensively, the Rangers line up with Mark McLemore in left field, Otis Nixon in center. Rusty Greer plays right. Dean Palmer at third base. Benji Gill's the shortstop, Jeff Fry at second, and Jack Voigt plays first. Yvonne Rodriguez behind the plate, and Kevin Gross, the pitcher for game one. Kevin really struggling at 1-3 with a 10.35 earned run average in five starts. A lot of hits given up, a lot of opportunities to score, 29 in 20 innings. But look at that walk total, 20. 16 strikeouts is good, but too many chances for the other team to score. His last outing against the Blue Jays, he beat them in 5 1/3. Gave up 7 earned runs and still won. 8 hits, 2 walks, and 5 strikeouts. So, Sox, it would be good to be patient this afternoon against Kevin Gross. Let's see if they can do it. Buckaroo.
So here's Lance Johnson hitting at 239. No homers, he's knocked in 4. And as you saw, John Kruk batting cleanup in the DH spot. Chris Sabol has been designated for a reassignment. First pitch from the big 6'5 right-hander. Fastball hit up the middle. Jeff Fry backhands it, plants, guns. In time, one pitch, one out. So a quick out, and that'll bring up Tim Raines. Rock hitting at 309. Four homers, he's knocked in 17. Rock has faced Gross 39 times in his career, and he has 13 hits, all of which stayed in the park.
It's about 333, isn't it?
Yeah. And before we show you our picks to click, you at home select yours. Fastball strike, poured over by Gross, and the count nothing and one. Little slider down and in, and very quickly 0-2. And let's check out our picks to click this afternoon. Skip Ellison, our producer, director, and crew went with Krupp. Wimpy went with One Dog. I'm going with Robin. There's a Kruckmeister. 5'10", 215 pounds.
Right.
That breaking ball inside. So the count 1-2 to Raines.
He's svelte. Well, he's not svelte, but he's real solid. Really. I saw him yesterday.
Yes.
He's what?
He's solid. What, do you think I'd lie?
Wouldn't you? I told you what you could do about lying. Wimpy, that book's got into your head. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Fastball, Jeff Fry, short hop. Two gone. So here comes the big hurt. Frank hitting at 299. Five homers. And he's knocked in 17. In game two of this doubleheader this afternoon, it'll be Alex Fernandez against Roger Pavlik. Outfield, for the most part, straight up. Now Nixon a couple of steps over towards Rusty Greer and right. As that pitch catches the outside corner. Curveball misses, 1-1. Gross, a variety of breaking pitches. Checks it up on that fastball inside half. And it's a 1-2 count. In his career, he has won 121 times. He has lost 137 times. But 20 walks and 20 innings thus far.
Yeah.
Slider. And poof, checking out the walk leaders. Al Leiter, southpaw with the Blue Jays. Jason Gross. Mike Moore.
Yeah, that's a surprise. Mike Moore is usually very good with his
control. Well, both Moore and Gross are a surprise.
Yeah, yeah. Uh-oh.
Drops down, misses that outside corner, and the count evens at 2.
There's that illegal pitch from anybody over 6 feet tall. Gross 6'5 coming from Laredo right there, and he dotted the outside corner. That ball must have just missed.
That ball wasn't even close, Duke.
It wasn't.
That ball hit in the center field. Otis Nixon. So a 1-2-3 inning for Kevin Gross, and after one, no score. Southwest Airlines, tail of the tape. No score, top of the second inning. For Texas, it'll be McLemore, Jack Voigt, and Rusty Greer to face Wilson Alvarez, 25-year-old southpaw. What a start Mark McLemore is off to. 395, a homer, and he's knocked in 15. Oh, the 30-year-old switch hitter takes a strike. McLemore in his career has faced Wilson 11 times and has three hits. Yeah, you see, 12 for 21 in the last seven. That's good. Fastball misses the outside corner. And a shot base hit. He's honing. Lead man aboard. And a reminder, the first 20,000 fans attending the Friday, June 2nd Sox game with the Tigers will receive a Kodak White Sox All-Star poster. And this poster features 1994 White Sox, Frank Thomas, Wilson Alvarez, and Jason Bure, also Gene Lamont. Game time is 7:05, so for tickets, just dial 312-831, one Sox. That's Friday, June 2nd. First 20,000 fans at All-Star poster. Here's the first baseman, Jack Voigt. 3-for-7 on the season. There goes McLemore. The Voyeur. Ozzy backing up. Stolen base, number 8 for McLemore.
Well, what a great acquisition Mark McLemore was. I'll tell you, he got a real good jump on Wilson. Spanky came out of the chute as well as he could. The throw was to the third base side of the bag, but he really had no chance. McLemore leading the American League in hitting, probably at that 400 mark right now, plus 8 stolen bases. So what a great asset he's been.
Better keep an eyeball on him in a second. Short lead. Voigt takes a breaking ball inside, and he's on top in the count 2-0. Three and oh the count to Jack Voigt. Rangers coming in hitting 282 as a team. They have a team ERA of 4.84. They have 23 homers on the season. Sox have 21. Sox hitting 277 as a club with a 5.22 team ERA. There's a fastball strike. Rangers really have not been playing that well defensively. They also have committed a huge number of errors, 25.
That's not good, but 33 is a lot worse.
Wilson wanted that pitch from Joyce, didn't get it, and that's ball four. So the second walk issued by Alvarez, and that'll bring up Rusty Greer as the Sox come in at the corners looking for the bunt.
Yeah, you'd think with a lefty versus lefty matchup here that Greer would be bunting.
Outfield spread out, swung around to the left, squares the bunt, and it's going foul.
What a way to get on TV.
See, now these people,
nice going, guys.
These people know what you should be called.
Not. Somebody get over there with a magic marker.
Put Duke in there?
Yes. Well, you can get Hawk out of there, too.
No balls, one strike to Rusty Greer. Once again, he squares the bunt.
Two-stroke penalty, isn't it?
Fouls that pitch off, and the count 0-2. He didn't double hit that ball,
Duke. He didn't?
Duke.
He didn't hit it behind himself? Look at this. This should be a two-stroke penalty. One. Boom. Two.
No, that ball came back and hit him. See, you double hit the ball.
I know.
That
I
was not a double hit
I want,
there.
Too.
Anybody can throw it over their left shoulder with a sand wedge, I'll tell you one thing. You're awesome. Here's the 0-2. Curveball just off the corner. No score top of the second, but the Rangers threatening with two on, nobody out. Big man right here for Alvarez. Benji Gill, the on deck hitter, as the 1-2. There's a base hit, fastball. They're going to wave McLemore around. He'll score, and then Texas jumps out on top. 1-0. So Mark McLemore singles to start it off, steals second, and scores on the line drive single by Rusty Greer.
He got too good of a pitch here on 1-2. Spanky is setting up outside. This is center cut. Boy, watch how he stays back nicely. The head doesn't move a whole lot. Little inside out action. You see those hands coming through before the barrel of the bat. And he laces it in the left field for an RBI single. Greer now with 14 runs batted in on the season.
And here's the 22-year-old shortstop, Benji Gill, hitting at 296, four homers. He's knocked in 13. He's off to a good start. Changed his stance a little bit since spring training. Can't get that heater. Nothing in one.
That's interesting. I'll tell you, he goes up there cutting and slashing. Got his hands down way, way low, and then he brings them up as the pitcher's delivering.
Fakes the bunt, takes the ball, and the count 1-1. Right on three hits for Texas. No runs on, no hits for the Sox as Kevin Gross retired the side in order. Bottom of the first. Now Gill wants to talk to Jerry Nairn, third base coach. A little bonding time, you know, for the young players and veteran coaches.
Right. I like that.
Yeah. That goes hand in hand in concert with your book.
Yes.
Jim Shorts.
Is it wrong? Right.
Have you seen those Jim Shorts?
Oh.
Sports vignettes.
Yes.
There's a bunt. Wilson got to play at third, and he makes it.
Whoa! Yes.
So the bunt right back to Alvarez. That forces Voit at third, and a big out.
Big out right there. Keeps the double play in order. Not a good bunt by Benji Gill. It's too close to Wilson. Wilson's got to be charging the third baseline, although he falls off the rubber to the first base side. This is right back at him. Becomes that fifth infielder, and good stretch there by Robin Ventura, turning himself into a first baseman. It was bang bang, but he definitely got him.
So here's Nixon. He flied to his counterpart Lance Johnson, leading off the ball game. To mention, Otis, 36 years old. Want to know the count? Man.
I
Up high.
That was about belt high right
there. 2-0. Greer at second, Gill at first. There's a strike on the inside corner. Otis has swiped at least 37 bases for seven straight seasons. That's in the right field. Mike Devereaux makes the catch. So that's out number two. And if you're just joining us, John Kruk is in the lineup this afternoon. He will be leading off the bottom half of this inning. Also, as we mentioned, Chris Sabo has been designated for reassignment. There's the Kruckster. 5'10", 215.
Yep, that's what it says.
It's Jeff Fry. Jeff popped up to Ventura.
Was that at his communion?
Curveball inside, I guess. And the count, 1-0. Now, field for the most part, straight up. Lance just a couple of steps over towards Tim Raines. Fry, in his short major league career, done some damage against the Sox. Pretty good hack at a heater. There you see, in 10 ball games, seems like the. For sure, at least two of those RBIs have won games for Texas.
He's a good player. I'll tell you, he's had a lot of injury problems in the past. One time, would he fall off a curb and broke his ankle, missed the season. A lot of strange things have happened to Jeff Fry.
There's a base hit right back through the middle. So here comes Greer. Throw cut off. And it's 2-0 Rangers.
Well, Jeff Fry just dials it up for the fastball right here. Boom, it's pretty much center cut, about thigh high. Boy, those hands stayed back nicely. Head's not moving. Okay, they've swung the bat well so far throughout this Texas lineup. It's a different look, Texas team. More speed-oriented than we've seen in the past. Looks like a lot better team than what we saw in 94.
Here's Mickey Tettleton. He drew a walk last inning. Dick Bosman on the right. Ranger pitching coach. Ball up and in. Outfield playing him to pull as Gill at second, Fry at first, and then the count moves to 2-0 on Tettleton. Have some activity down in the Sox pen. Right-hander Jose De Leon. Three and oh the count. Better put a little giddy up on it. That's ball four. That'll load him up. And Jackie Brown out to the mound. And certainly our congratulations go out to Jackie Brown and his team, the Lovelace boys, for capturing the Hawk Open.
Wow, what a thrill that must be for them.
19 under, they were on a great golf course, Seven Bridges.
Yeah, you better check that, recheck that. They did have an eraser on their pencil. We know that.
And we want to thank, certainly, Roger Warren and his staff out of Seven Bridges for such a fine and outstanding job. Duke, I want to thank you for being on the 15th hole out there and playing a hole with every group that came through. We had a full house, 36 foursomes, fivesomes. I certainly want to thank Ed Farmer for helping us acquire some of those magnificent gifts that we had. But first and foremost, I want to thank Christine Makowski.
Oh, yeah, she was great.
Christine does all the work for that Hawk Open, and 2 years in a row we've had a very successful tournament, raised a whole bunch of money for White Sox charities. So our thanks go out to Christine.
Yeah, Gene Honda also, who was with me on that 15th hole, and all the White Sox personnel who gave up their time to come out. That was great.
Great day. Beautiful day.
Oh, man.
1-0 the count to Dean Palmer. This angle sharply back through the middle last inning. Looks at that fastball up high, and it's 2-0.
This is the smallest strike zone in the league right here.
Well, it's the smallest strike zone we've seen all year. The 2-0. Gas. Reach back and put another 5 or 6 inches on that one. Well, when you get a small strike zone like that, from a pitching standpoint, makes it tough. From a hitting standpoint, makes it great.
Oh, man. Well, you don't have to swing at anything even close to your belt.
No. Two.
And anybody with a good fastball, you take it above the belt, you get something around thigh high and just drop the head on it. If that's all you're concerned about is to drop the head, if you're patient enough to wait for a pitch, you can really do some damage.
There you see Dean with 4 grand slams in his career. Here's the 2-2. Foul tip. Spanky hung on to it. Nice job by Lavalier. And that'll retire the side, but the Angels get on the board. 2 runs, 3 hits, no errors, 3 left. And after an inning and a half, 2-0 bad guys. Two-nothing Texas, bottom of the second inning for the Sox. It'll be John Kruk to lead it off. He'll be followed by Robin Ventura and Mike Devereaux to face Kevin Gross. Well, a nice round of applause for the 34-year-old veteran, John Kruk. That guy can relate to him.
Yeah. I bet he's his favorite player.
There's his numbers last year with the Phillies in 75 games as Kevin Gross. Fastball in on a fist. Well, he certainly is a blithe spirit.
Yes.
A free spirit. Off the plate and the count 1-1. Outfield shading him around to the left. Here's the 1-1. Change up. So Kruk on top. 2 balls and a strike. Kruk in 1993 hit 316, 14 homers, knocked in 85 with the Phillies. 92 hit 323, 10 homers, knocked in 70. It's 3-1. He is a lifetime 300 hitter with 98 homers, 569 knocked in. That's ball 4. Francisco Kruk. First Sox base runner.
He failed to mention how many bases he stole during that time.
Hey, don't get on the Krukster. He had 4 stolen bases last year.
That's good.
He had 10 in 1990. He had 18 in 1987.
Well, he's doing the first thing every good base runner does. He checks to see where the outfielders are playing so he doesn't have to look when the ball is hit.
Here's Robin. Robin hitting at 288, 4 homers. He's knocked in 14. Two nothing Rangers here in the bottom of the second inning. Up high and the count 1-1. See, Robin's starting to get that thing cranked up a little bit. 448. 1-5. Nice block by Ivan Rodriguez. So it's a 2-1 count. Good. Great food here at Comiskey Park. And a shot base hit in the right field. Kruk will hold at second, so here come the Sox with 2 on, nobody out.
Well, the count will usually dictate how well you're going to hit. Robin got a 2-1 fastball right down Broadway, and he did not miss it. Boy, that head stayed perfectly still. The contact out in front of home plate. Bang.
Well, we talked about Robin the last 10 days. Also, Mike Devereaux. Let's check out Hoover's Who's Cleaning Up in Baseball. Brought to you by all the good folks from Hoover. McLemore, look at McLemore, 480. Devereaux, 450. Robin, 448. Tim Neary, Carmine's, 429. And Manny Ramirez, 424. Hoover's Who's Cleaning Up in Baseball. There's a curveball outside. See Devereaux up to 328, a couple of homers. He's knocked in 9. It up the middle. Here comes Kruk. They're going to wave him around. Here's the throw by Otis Nixon. Not in time. Kruk scores, and it's a 2-1 ball game. RBI number 10 for Mike Devereaux.
Never a doubt Kruk was going to score. I was really surprised Terry Bevington sent him, to be honest with you. Nixon, of course, he is picking up a very wet baseball. See, Mike Devereaux, the slider hit it off the end of the bat, but good enough to get to center field. That's probably the reason that Otis was not able to throw him out. You see the ball just kind of slips out of his fingers. Kruk scores easily. It's a 2-1 ball game.
There was never a doubt that he was going to score. Duke?
No.
Durham tries to bunt it, fouls it back. Off Rodriguez in the count, nothing and 1. So a nice start by John Kruk, a walk in his first at bat, and he scores. Durham hitting at 316, no homers. He's knocked in 11. Corners in close. Palmer at the cut of the grass. Same for Voigt at first. Once again, he squares the bunt. This time takes the ball. And it's 1-1. Gross last year with the Dodgers 9-7 with a 3.60 ERA. 157 innings, only walked 43. He did have 124 punch outs. That's a good ratio.
Yeah.
Here's the 1-1. Lays out. Watch out. Oh, boy. Ball hits Robin, who now he's up. He's on his way to third. He will get there. Good throw right there, and he is a gone goose.
Yes, sir. Especially the way Rodriguez can throw.
The ball hit him. Hope he's all right.
Oh, you got him in the wrist. Take a look. Boy, that's the toughest thing in the world, because you want to get a good jump as that base runner at second. And you got to be on guard against the rifle arm of a Rodriguez. That ball did hit Robin. I think it short hopped him on the wrist. Yep. No button now.
Here's a 2-1. Shot foul. Nice Ooh. Play by the ball girl.
Piece of cake.
Well, Rodriguez is the last guy in this league you want to get hit by.
Yeah. Short hop or whatever. Hopefully Robin's okay.
Looks at that breaking ball and a full count to Durham. Rays last seven games here at Comiskey Park. He has seven RBIs while hitting a smooth 455. Two, four, and one for the Rangers. 1-2 and 0 for the good guys. With runners at the corners, nobody out. Off the end of the bat. Greer over to Gill. They will not turn this as Ventura scores, and the game is tied at 2.
Not hit hard enough. Jeff Fry, Benji Gill did just about everything they could, but they're not going to double up Ray Durham. And you can see the Sox were not running on 3-2 in respect of Ivan Rodriguez's arm in case of a strikeout.
Here's Mike LaValliere. Spanky hitting at 200. No homers. He's knocked in two. He has faced Gross 49 times in his career. He has 13 hits against Kevin, 12 of which stayed in the park.
One homer. Cool.
First and third in Spanky. There goes Durham. Palmer backs up, plays it nicely. Over to Voit. So that's out number two.
Well, Michael Valier's a good hit and run man. 1-0 pitch coming up. Gross, although he does have a lot of walks, he's been a control pitcher his entire career. And Spanky hit the ball on the ground like he's supposed to, but right at the third baseman.
Here's Ozzy. Ozzy hitting at 322. No homers. He's knocked in 9. Now feels short. Swung well around to the left. Pretty big gap out there in center and right center. Yeah, there's a nice block by Rodriguez. So it certainly appears this might be a hitter's delight this afternoon. There might be some points put on that board.
Well, you would think. I mean, if you got a center cut everything just about thigh high. You got anything, any patience whatsoever, you're going to get yourself a good count at least twice during the course of this ball game.
That's a great concept.
Yeah, it is. I wish I could have followed that.
Chops that breaking ball foul, and the count evens at one. So Durham at second. He's a go-ahead run. Gross set. Durham with the lead. A breaking ball down and in. So it's one and two.
And fans, you can get the cap the pros wear at the New Era Cap Corner at Comiskey Park, located in left field corner of the main concourse. It features a large variety of New Era authentic diamond collection caps, the caps worn by the Chicago White Sox and all other major and minor league baseball teams. Be sure and visit the New Era Cap Corner this season when you come and visit Comiskey Park.
Nice caps.
Oh, beautiful.
That's a new era you were sporting there,
it
Duke.
It certainly is.
That's a new era that I'm sporting, a new era. Well, no, Ozzie's not sporting a new era.
Ozzie's wearing the helmet I think Luke Appling wore.
Old Aches and Pains back in 1934. Another breaking pitch, another souvenir, and the count hangs at one and two. So the 1-2 count, two out here in the bottom of the second to Ozzie, and a 2-2 tie. Let's pause for our station identification.
This is America's number one sports station, WGN-TV, Chicago.
Along with Whimperoo, the Duke. His nibs, the inevitable. Tom Pachorek, this is Ken Harrelson from Comiskey Park. I'll be bringing all the insights, the nuances. This particular game, everything you want to know about the Rangers and the Sox in the first meeting of the year.
Wow.
As he picks that one off his shoe tops. And the count one and two.
How did he hit this ball? Ball. That was going to hit him in the foot.
That looks like you going after a 60-yard wedge shot.
Oh, man. Good follow through. And Ozzie hitting 356.
Another nuance right by the Wimperoo.
Yeah.
Hello. There's a shot. Fry with a dive. Comes up with it. Nice catch by Jeff Fry. And that'll retire the side. But the Sox tied up with two runs on two hits, one error, one left after two, tied at two.
Two-two tie, top of the third inning. Our Southwest Airlines tail of the tape. Rangers have committed an error. They've gotten four hits already off Wilson Alvarez. Sox with two against Kevin Gross. So Wilson, who dominated these guys last year, of course, is the new-look Texas lineup. Otis Nixon, new on the ball club. Mark McLemore is now leading the American League in hitting. Mickey Tettleton, a new face. And here's Ivan Rodriguez. He's an old face. Still a youngster, though. We saw Ivan play his first game. There's a curveball strike. Got married that day, got his first hit. He is an up-and-coming star, already an all-star in the American League. There's the 0-1 grounded foul. Wide of Jerry Nairn, the third base coach. Rodriguez, just 23 years old. Man. Already has three full seasons in the major leagues. We saw him in 1991 make his debut. Last year, Ivan hit a solid 298, 16 homers. So he's a Good looking young hitter. Fouls that one back on the screen. Rodriguez, a pretty good high ball hitter, which is something you don't see very often in the major leagues anymore. Everybody, it's become a low ball league, both the American and National. But you'll see Rodriguez get up on top of a high fastball every once in a while, and a good fastball at that. Hits the ball to all fields, outfield deep and straight away. He's tardy on the fastball, fouls it off to the right. And while we have a moment, I want to wish my sister Marilyn a very happy birthday, a day late, in lieu of an expensive gift, of course. We're not going to say how old she is, but she is my baby sister. And a big hi to my mom and dad. I know they're watching the game today in Grand Blanc, Michigan. It's Marilyn McDaniel. Change up. Boy, he kept his hands back there, rips it in the left field. Wilson gave that pitch away. Slowed up his delivery, got it up high, and Rodriguez didn't miss it. The only thing that saved Wilson there was away. If that's on the inner half of the plate, it might have been so long. Long. Here's Mark McLemore hitting at 402. As we mentioned, the American League's leading hitter coming in, and he still is that with that one for one, a stolen base and a run scored. Fakes the bunt, please bunt. Better chance of getting him out. He now has an 8-game hitting streak. Wow, came in with a 7-gamer, 571. Whew. He's now 13 for 22 in his last few ball games. So McLemore, certainly the hottest hitter in this league. Takes a fastball strike inside corner. Good pitch. And here's our American League leaders. McLemore, Manny Ramirez, ooh, that youngster from Cleveland. What a player he is. Chili Davis, Carlos Baerga, and Tim Nehring. Top five hitters in the American League, they can hit. Throw over, Rodriguez gets back easily. He has not attempted a stolen base so far in the season. McLemore got his 8th just last inning. Otis Nixon has 7 on the ball club also. McLemore and Nixon, the top 2 threats on this team. McLemore fouls that one off to the right. Talk mentioned, McLemore is 30 years old. Hey, a couple years ago, he was the best offensive player on that Baltimore Oriole team. He hit .284, 72 runs batted in, stole 21 bases, and he played everywhere. Played the outfield, second base. Very valuable player on that team. Last year, slumped a little bit. Now he hit .257 in 104 ball games. He was a free agent. Texas scooped him up, and he has been a great acquisition. Liked him years ago when he was with the Angels. Good speed. Sox playing him straight away and deep in the outfield. Curveball, had him out front. He fouls it at home plate. There's the skipper, Gene Lamont, trying to get the Sox off that snide. Sox have lost their last 3. The Rangers have won 6 of the last 7. And the Rangers have beaten the last 3 left-handed starters that they have faced after losing 9 in a row to southpaw starters. That's grounded foul, out ahead of the curveball. Wow, look at this. Left-handed batting .377, right-handed .440. Whoa. 1-2. Fastball jammed him. Little pop-up right side. Ray Durham in shallow right field makes the catch. Good play by Ray. Boy, he's got as much range as I think anybody I've seen in a long, long time going out in the outfield. He makes it look easy.
He does. He really makes it look easy. He probably makes it look about as easy as any second baseman in this league. In the range, as you mentioned, I don't think there's anybody, including range on those pop-ups like that, including Roberto Alomar, who has more.
Yeah. Oh, he's something. He goes out in right field, center, left center to make plays. Keeps that duck snort out of play.
That's the one we're only talking about range in comparison with Alomar on the pop-ups.
Yeah. Tell you what, Ray has thrown some leather, too. He has really improved on ground balls and making plays that way, turning the double play.
Well, at 23 years old, he should, with his talent. You know, he's a real deal. He should just get better and better. One of these days, he will get out of the habit of catching that ball back in his stance or back between his legs.
Yeah, I think that's his biggest weakness in his entire game. Voigt, 1-0 pitch coming up. Jack Voigt walked his first time up. He was forced at third base as Benji Gill tried to bunt him over there last inning. 2-2 tie. The Rangers have 5 hits in this game already. Wilson Alvarez to Michael Vollier. Fastball hit in the air high to left field. Tim Raines back to the warning track and makes the catch. Whoa, he just missed that one. Tagging. And moving on in the second base is Ivan Rodriguez. Good hustle there when he knew that Raines was going to make the play. Tell you what, Voigt came real close to hitting that ball out of here. That was a high fastball out of the strike zone. Jack just got underneath it. And our next telecast coming your way on WGN will be Friday from Detroit. 6 p.m. Central Time, and we have a dugout show for you at 5:30. Rich King will be the host. And we'll be there. We won't, I understand. Fastball inside. I understand they're going to move us from our perch. Locker room way upstairs.
Oh, that'll be a lot of fun.
That'll be brutal. I understand they turned our booth into a suite. Weren't they supposed to do that?
Yeah,
hopefully they won't.
To.
Yeah. There's a shot in the center field. Rusty Greer now 2-for-2. Lance charging. The throw home. And they, oh no, it's dropped by Lavalier. Rodriguez scores. And it's a 3-2 Ranger lead. Greer in the second base. Boy, Lance gave it a good shot there. He charged it. And Spanky looks like he might be hurt. Boy, Greer got another center cut fastball and he drives it. Now 2-for-2 with a couple of runs batted in. Lance with the throw right there. He did kind of short hop him. And when Mike Lavalier went to put the throw on Rodriguez, good slide by Yvonne going the opposite way of the tag. Watch his bounce. Watch the high bounce he gets here.
He gets a terrible bounce. If the ball bounces true at all, he's a dead duck. And Spanky put his right hand down, and the right cleat there of Rodriguez got him. He had no chance on that hop. There's that right cleat dragging across his hand.
Wow. No, Lance with a solid throw home, but as we mentioned, that bad bounce. Wow, looks like it got right there, the cut between the grass and the dirt. As you look at Benji Gill, put his hands way down, raises them, swings through a fastball. Thank you. Benji 0 for 1. That fielder's choice we talked about earlier tried to bunt last inning. Alvarez forced the play at third. Sox playing the hit the opposite way in the outfield. Gill fouls that back. You like that move he's making with his hands way down?
No.
I don't either.
Reminds me too much of Eric Davis. That's a tough move, I'll tell you. That's a tough move to make. But, you know, at his age, he's just a youngster yet, 22 years old. He's going to go through a lot of trial and error processes.
Yeah. Well, he's got his hands way down there by his belt. Yeah, I don't like, well, yeah, Eric Davis proved to us the last couple of years he just couldn't get him back up, and he refused to change.
Yeah, but he also, prior to that, though, he had some big years with that stance over in Cincinnati. And certainly, I think Gill would have a chance to hit from there because he is strong. But he just looks uncomfortable.
Yeah, it does. And he's still dropping his hands. He's bringing them up, and he's still dropping them again. So I think that what they're trying to do with him is to get him from dropping those hands and cocking them upward, but he still brings them up, drops them again, and then comes to the ball. That timing mechanism has got to suffer.
One thing about it, from that position, though, if you get that timing mechanism working, you can hit it 9 miles.
Yes, you can.
I mean, you can kowtow it.
Yeah, see, he's got a double pumping motion almost as he pops this one to the right side. Frank Thomas. Oh, he got it. And that'll do it. But the Rangers come up with one run on two hits, leave a runner after two and a half. They lead it 3-2. Aren't these guys supposed to be in school today? Some of the young happy campers here at the ballpark. 3-2 Rangers. Oh, it's the school day. Look, Maddox School is here today. Big welcome to all the youngsters here in attendance. First of two between the Sox and the Texas Rangers. And we're already in the third inning of game one. And you know, all fans attending the Saturday, June 3rd, White Sox game against Detroit will be treated to a spectacular fireworks display following the game, compliments of Vienna Beef. Game time 6:05, and you can get your tickets by calling 312-831-1-SOX, and we just love those fireworks. Really the highlight of our week. They're great. Here's Lance Johnson. My pick to click this afternoon. Lance 0 for 1 grounded out. Nice play by Jeff Fry at second base as he backhanded it. He went after first pitch fastball. He does the same thing this time, hits it deep to right. But Rusty Greer right there to make the play. So Lance 2 for 2, 0 for 2 that is, on two pitches. And that'll bring up the rock, Tim Raines. Tim grounded the second, his first time up. And it's that time of the year again. The National Polish American Sports Hall of Fame has got three new inductees. All right. Zeke Bratkowski, the former great quarterback, Barney McCoskey, former great baseball player, and Frank Szymanski are the three. Tim Raines takes it down low. It's going to be June 8th at the Hall of Fame Museum on the campus of Orchard Lake St. Mary's College in Orchard Lake, Michigan. That's great. Everybody remembers Zeke Bratkowski, the great backup for the Packers with Bart Starr. Former Georgia Bulldog, Skip Ellison points out. You're right, he is a former dog. Barney Mikowski, lifetime 312 hitter. That's not too shabby in 11 years. Frank Szymanski starred at Notre Dame. College All-Star game. Tim Raines hits it deep. Greer going back. Way back. It is gone. Home run, Raines. The Rock goes deep for the fifth time this season. And we're tied again at 3. Hello. 18 runs batted in for Tim Raines. Looked like he got up above a high fastball and drove it into the Ranger bullpen. Let's check it out. Up and away, and it goes. Up and away. Yes. Here's Big Frank. Takes a curveball up and in.
Now you're chunking, Duke.
Boy, that's my first run in a long time, isn't it?
Yes.
Well, we're even. Frank Thomas, 2-0. Frank flies to center on a curveball from Gross in the first inning. Kevin had a 1-2-3 first, and then he gave up two runs on two hits in the second. Another run here in the third. We're tied at 3. 3-0. There's John Kruk, who walked and scored last inning. Fastball right there. Three and one. I'm with you. I'm going to take a swat at that one. He walked him. Second walk issued by Kevin Gross. And that'll bring up the Kruckster. John Kruk walked and scored in his first American League at bat. John played in the minor leagues with Ozzie Guillen, a former Padre. Just one of many that the Pods let get away. Well, they must have had a great minor league scouting system or amateur scouting system to get all these great players. That's fouled off to the left. Breaking ball. But one thing on those off-speed pitches so far, Kruk has really kept his hands back nicely. Been just a little bit tardy on the fastball, but that timing mechanism will get there. As long as those hands stay back, you got a chance. Change up, misses away. Fish weren't biting again. 2-1. John spent 5 full seasons with Philadelphia. Actually 5.5. 2.5 with the Pods. No. 3-1. Frank Thomas at first, 3-3 tie. You got the hit sign, big boy. Terry Boom Boom Bevington over at third base giving the signals. Doug Manzolino over at first. Outfield swung around to left and he walked him again. Third walk issued by Gross. Second time Kruk has walked. Let's see, did John walk a lot last year? 42 times in 255 at bats. The year before, he walked 111 times, so good eye. He'll give you that quality at bat. There's Dick Bosman out to the mound to have a word with Kevin Gross. Tell you one thing, the thing I remember about Kevin Gross the most talk is the fact he had a biting curveball. I don't see that today. Kind of rolling.
That's one reason he's been having some problems. 1-3 with a 10.25 ERA, Duke.
You think so?
Good chance.
Boy, you're pretty observant, you know that. How about those
20
walks?
Well, only if you bring it up, see, after you.
Why don't you get balls? Yeah, when you walk 20 innings. But I remember, you know, seeing him with the Phillies years ago. Boy, he had an outstanding curveball, biter. And he was not afraid. Terry Burrows in the Ranger bullpen, but he was not afraid to throw that hook at any time during the count and get it over. And as you mentioned earlier, he's always been a control pitcher. So far with the Rangers, I don't know if he's having trouble with that release point or whatever. but he's been in trouble. And here's trouble again. Robin Ventura swinging the daylights out of the bat. Robin, a solid single. And a run scored last inning. Takes one up high, kept his hands back nicely again.
Well, that certainly is one of the huge, big, most important things about hitting. You talked about Kruk earlier when he looked at that pitch. Keeping those hands back, you've got to find a way to keep the hands back. Those hands start sliding with you as you make your commitment to the pitch, you're dead.
Yep.
At that point, it becomes then the ball has got to hit your bat.
That's right. Oh, boy. He popped that one up in the infield. Dean Palmer. Robin got underneath that one. Home run in a telephone booth. Second out of the inning. Yeah, you're right, Hawk. When those hands move forward, you can't dial it up for the fastball. You're going to be tardy on that, or you don't have any bat speed for one. And the curveball, you're already spent. Mike Devereaux had an RBI single his first time up. Mike hitting at 338 as he stands in. He's been red hot. Two homers, 10 driven in now on the season. Got a chance to do some more damage. Ray Durham on deck. First pitch curveball just misses. Boy, that is a tight strike zone today. This is a hitter's delight, especially a guy like Kevin Gross who's really struggling with his control. And his curveball being his best pitch, you take that away from him, he's in big trouble. High fastball. Uh-oh. Devereaux in the driver's seat, Hawk, and you pointed out so many times when he's ahead in the count. He has really been dangerous this year.
He's just been, when he was on top in the count this last 2 weeks, he's been almost what you'd call automatic.
Yeah. Well, we'll see what Gross throws him on 2-0. Fastball paints. Woo. Outside corner. Got to just spit on that one. Mike now at a 5-game hitting streak, 10 for his last 18. Up high, 3-1. So the hitter's delight once again. A lot of pitches being thrown in three innings by both pitchers. Misses inside. I don't know if that was a curveball that got away or a changeup. Devereaux walks. Fourth one issued by Gross, so he is keeping up with his average of at least a walk an inning. Sacks full of socks. A White Sox on every base. And Ray Durham, the hitter. Ray had an RBI as he reached on a fielder's choice last inning, grounded hard to second. Jeff Fry will get the out at second, and that'll do it. Sox, though, come up with a run on the solo shot by Tim Raines. Leave three after three. We're tied at three.
Southwest Airlines, tail of the tape here in the top of the fourth. 3-6-1 for the Rangers. 3-3-0 for the good guys. For Texas, it'll be the top of the order. Otis Nixon, Jeff Fry, and Mickey Tettleton to face Wilson Alvarez. Rangers have stranded six through the first three innings. So here's Otis. He's flied to center, and he's flied to right. Corner's in close. Takes a bunt, takes a fastball strike. Otis hitting at 274 as he stands in. As we mentioned, no homers, but he has knocked in 15 already this year. That's a lot of RBIs for him.
That is. That's a lot for him. Why?
Durham sucks it up and throws him out.
His hands out front that time. The guy that tells you those guys on the bottom of the lineup are getting on base.
And let's check out our Aflac trivia question. Who are the two players to be named Rookie of the Year in one league and MVP in the other?
Ooh. Joe Carter. Why would I think of that? Rookie of the Year in one league and MVP in the other. Any ideas? Must be the subject of a very large trade.
Tim Fry takes a fastball strike outside corner.
Wouldn't be Ted Simmons. Got a guess?
I have no clue. Change up, high off the plate, count 1-1. Wimpy, I'm in deep concentration here trying to get them out 1-2-3, if you don't mind. Wilson's been struggling. He needs an easy inning.
Hey, far be it from me
That's
to get in your
exactly
way.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Curveball strike, yes, Wilson. Just let him chunk and let me just go ahead and do the thinking.
I'll think about this answer.
Now feel straight up. Now Wilson backs it off to the 28-year-old second sacker of the Texas Rangers. Hard hit. Robin sucks it up. Thank you very much. Yes. Nice play, Ventura. Two out.
This ball's hit like a bullet. I'll tell you, that Jeff Fry's good-looking hitter. Robin to his side. That's the best way to see the ball. You get in front of that, you might just get in the chops. Robin, a good view. Makes the play. Two gone.
Here's Tettleton. Been to the plate twice. He's walked twice. Takes a curveball. And the count 1-0. Mickey with that very distinctive stance. He gets shot off right there. You're talking about an explosion. Mickey didn't know where the ball went. Yeah, that bat just went flying past Alvarez.
Boy, it's tough to get a good piece of wood.
Boy, it is real tough.
Mickey.
Explosion time.
I'll tell you, he hit that with his fingernails. That was way deep in there. What about?
That's all you can do is laugh.
Oh, yeah. Got to. Is that vintage Doc Edwards right there?
Close. Kark so far is running number one in the Doc Edwards shot this year.
Yeah, that's the jam of the maybe of the decade.
He just laughs about it, too. There's a good curveball strike. So Alvarez on top, 1-2 to the 34-year-old veteran. Six homers, 17 knocked in. Another hook, and Mickey just over the top of it. First of what we hope to be a doubleheader this afternoon from Comiskey Park. Fastball, 2-2. We understand it. In the event we cannot get both games or any game in, looks pretty good right now. Both teams have an off day, but they will not play tomorrow, so we're liable to be here a while this afternoon. Wimpy?
Good chance. Hey, we've done this before.
Got him on the inside corner. 1-2-3 inning for Alvarez. His second strikeout. And after 3.5, tied at 3.
Bottom of the fourth inning, 3-3 tie. Rangers have doubled up the Sox on hits at 6-3. And the only long ball in this ball game supplied by The Rock. Tim Raines last inning hit a high fastball off Kevin Gross into the bullpen in right center field. So both pitchers have been struggling, although Wilson Alvarez did work a 1-2-3 top half the fourth inning. Here's Spanky LaValliere. Mike grounded the third on a hit and run play. That was in the second. Kevin Gross, first pitch, fastball, misses up and away. Outfield swung way around the left field. Boy, McLemore in left field is practically guarding the line. 2-0. I'll tell you one thing, Gross has really been pitching from behind in the count all afternoon. Sox got to take advantage of that situation as he pours that fastball on the outside corner. All other activity is in the night time. Minnesota at Detroit. Milwaukee's at Cleveland. Come on, Brew Crew. Spanky hits this one left center. No problem for Nixon. One out. And here's our Aflac trivia question and answer. It's a good question, John Walgren. Who are the two players in the to be named Rookie of the Year in one league and MVP in the other? Frank Robinson, 1956 Rookie of the Year, National League, 66 MVP in the American League. Dick Allen also coming from the National League to the American League to go from Rookie of the Year to MVP. Great question. Couple of great players right there. Wow. Now they could hit. Ozzie takes fastball strike. Boy, he had a wicked shot to the left of Jeff Fry. That ended the second inning. Nice play by the Rangers second baseman. Saved Gross a run as there was a runner in scoring position. So Ozzie hits this one hard to left field. McLemore back. Oh, it's off his glove. He kind of coasted on it, so Ozzie will cruise in the second base. McLemore had a late jump. Then he went after it hard, and all of a sudden at the end, he felt like he had it easily. It hit off the end of his glove. We'll see how they rule it. Ozzie got on top of that high fastball, hands above the ball. Right off the watch it right here. Good concentration up until this point, and then it looks like he may have just lost sight of it at the end. It's a double. Thank you, Rob Rosenberg. So here's Lance Johnson. Jim Joyce making that batter's box outline a little bit more definitive. Lance right there on the back of the line. Lance has hit the ball hard twice, but 0 for 2. Tough hang with him. Line to right his last time. There's a shot just foul. Well, Lance hit the first pitch in all three at bats. That time he hooked it foul. Tim Raines on deck. Come on, one dog, let's get this run across and then maybe just pray for a little rain. Bottom of the fourth inning, 3-3 tie. The 0-1 pitch, fish ain't biting on the hook. Benji Gill jockeying with Ozzie Guillen at second base. Ozzie, a one-out double. As we mentioned, Minnesota at Detroit, Milwaukee at Cleveland, Kansas City at Toronto. Baltimore is at Oakland. You see what Lance has done with runners in scoring position, just 150. Uh-oh, did it hit him? No, that gets by Rodriguez. So Ozzie cruises in the third. That'll be a wild pitch. Boy, Gross really having trouble with that curveball of his. Man, hung on to it a bit too long. I don't know how Lance got out of the way of that. That pitch was almost behind him in the left-handed batter's box. 2-1 pitch coming up. The infield is in. Johnny Oates knows the threat of rain. There's a shot to left field, base hit. So the one dog comes through. Solid single. The Sox lead it 4-3. Oh, Lordy, that away one dog. And Lance, Ozzie, no way he could have scored from second base. Boy, that center cut fastball. Drop the head on it, Lance. Do it, one dog. You see the inside out swing, hands before the barrel. And we've got a 4-3 ball game. Sox leading. And here's Tim Raines. Rock hit that solo homer his last time up. That was his fifth dinger of the season. Hitting at 313 as he stands in. Changeup fades away. Frank Thomas on deck. John Kruk to follow. We're in the bottom of the fourth. Game one of this doubleheader. Lance, 7-for-8 in stolen bases, does not go as Rock shanks this one over the Sox dugout. Jeez. One fan tried to mug another one for that ball, and the good guy prevailed. There's one dog. Lance with his fifth run batted in of the season. Not going. Tim pops this one up left field. McLemore backing up now as the wind takes it. And that's the second out of the inning. Raines flies out, and that'll bring up Frank Thomas. And White Sox helmet banks will be given to the first 20,000 fans attending the White Sox game on Monday, June 5th, against the Toronto Blue Jays. Compliments of Dannon. Game time 7:05, and tickets can be purchased by calling 312-831-1-SOX. The big hurt is 0-for-1. A walk and a fly out. Quick throw over. Gross is not overly quick to home plate in his delivery. Big 6'5", 227 pounder. Drops down. That ball fades inside. When you drop down, you want it to be away. You don't want to throw it into the guy's bail. Oh, 1 to Frank, hitting at 295. Lance Johnson gets back easily. John Kruk, who has walked in his first two appearances in a White Sox uniform, is the on-deck hitter. In case you just joined us, Chris Sabo was designated for assignment today to make room for Kruk on the active roster. There goes Lance. Pitches a strike, the late throw in the center field. He's not going to be able to advance now as Lance didn't recognize it earlier. Boy, Rodriguez almost double clutching, didn't know if anybody was covering.
He did double clutch it. He had a real good shot at Lance right there, and just watch Rodriguez. Lance gets a decent jump. There it is, just that slight double clutch.
Frank Fastball, a good pitch to throw. I don't know if he recognized Lance was going. It looked like Fry was there in time. So the 1-1 pitch coming up to Thomas. Lance, stolen base number 8. He's only been caught one time. That away, one dog. You could very well easily win the big stick click. Starting to drizzle slightly. It never rains here. 1-2 coming up to Frank. Drops down, breaking ball, lined in the center field. Lance Johnson's going to score easily. Frank Thomas with the RBI single, and the good guys lead it 5-3. How do you do that? Fanny went one way, head the other, with a hand stayed back. That wasn't pretty as Gross dropped down, but he hung that pitch up a bit. Frank did keep his hands back. As everything was flying out of there, the hand stayed back. He's amazing. So the Big Hurt now with 18 runs batted in on the season. He and Raines are tied for the club leadership in that category. So here's John Kruk. High fastball, he went for it. Terry Burrows, the lefty, begins to throw once again. As once again, Kevin Gross is struggling. Down low, there's one strike and one ball on the hitter. The 1-1 pitch, change up down low. Two balls. John Kruk's last hit was a double August 10th against the New York Mets. Pitch, smoked. Oh, what a play by Boyd at first. He took extra bases away from the Kruckster. Wow. Sox, though, get two. They leave a runner. After four, good guys lead it 5-3. This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Chicago White Sox and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form without the express written consent of your Chicago White Sox. Well, don't even think about it, Pilgrim. Some visitors.
5-3 good guys here in the top of the fifth inning. Dean Palmer takes the curveball off the plate in the count 1-0. Palmer has singled and struck out with the bases loaded to end the second inning. 5-6-0 for the Sox, 3-6-1 for the Rangers. Outfield playing him the hook is that changeup high off the plate, so Alvarez behind in the count 2-0. Ivan Rodriguez on deck and Mark McLemore in the hole.
You didn't say anything about getting those two runs.
You're awesome.
Thanks. Gulp.
3-0. Just a slight drizzle falling here at the ballpark, and as we mentioned earlier, if you joined us late, it rained hard for the most part all morning. In fact, there, that's ball four. Four in a row thrown by Alvarez. So So here's Rodriguez. He is grounded to short, singled, and scored. Rodriguez, just 23 years old. He is now 4-for-8 lifetime off Wilson. Last time up, got a changeup and hammered it into left field for that base hit. Takes a fastball off the plate. Have activity down in the Sox pen. Right-hander Jose De Leon. Wilson had a tough inning in the first after retiring the first two hitters. He walked Tettleton, Palmer singled. Had a tough inning in the second when the Rangers picked up a couple of runs. They also had a tough inning in the third. So the fourth inning is really the only relatively easy inning that Alvarez has had. Outfield straight up for Rodriguez. He'll use the whole park. That ball hit way back. You can put it on the board. And this game is tied at 5. That's the first homer of the year for Ivan Rodriguez. He is now 5-for-9 lifetime off Alvarez.
He killed this one. 8 RBIs now. It's a fastball down and in. May have been just a get me over after 5 consecutive balls inside. Boy, he just led with that front elbow, that contact out in front, and goodbye. Never a doubt about this one.
Whew. Here's McLemore. He's 1-for-2. There's that pitch, souvenir right side. Five tie. There's that curveball dropped nicely in and over, and the count 0-2. That curveball hit hard. Nobody's going to get that one. Rock gets to it, cuts it off. McLemore, he's going to mosey on into second base, so the Rangers come out smoking here in the top of the fifth inning. Fourth two-bagger for McLemore. So as Jack Voigt makes his way into the plate, he is 0-for-1. He has walked. Now he just missed one back in the third. As Gene Lamont makes his way out to the mound, he probably has seen enough. And he has. He makes a sign to the pen. So Wilson Alvarez will depart. He works 4+ innings, facing 3 batters here in the top of the fifth. And we'll be back with the numbers on De Leon right after this.
And AT&T's first call to the bullpen is for Jose De Leon. Jose coming on in relief of Wilson Alvarez. Wilson struggled again this afternoon. 4+ innings, 5 runs on 8 hits. Jose is 2-0 with a 4.58 earned run average in his 9 relief appearances. Just 11 hits allowed in 17 2/3, 8 walks, 10 strikeouts for the big right-hander. He comes on with a runner at second base. Nobody out in a 5-5 tie. Here in the top half of the fifth inning. His last outing was Saturday against the California Angels. Well, John Voigt is going to stay in there and bat against De Leon. His job to hit the ball to the right side to get that runner to the third. for the next hitter, Rusty Greer, who is 2-for-2 with a couple of RBIs.
So here's Jack Voigt. He'll be hitting for John.
You want to see what his name really is?
John.
Well.
But they call him Jack.
I don't care. I call him by his real name.
Voigt has walked. Get him. And just missed one to left field. Corner's in close. As he is not bunting, there's that big hook from De Leon, and the count nothing and one.
Heck, if I was him, I'd want everybody to think I was John Voigt. Midnight Cowboy.
At least.
Deliverance.
A 5-5 tie. 5-8-1 for Texas, 5-6-0 for the Sox. First of what we hope to be a doubleheader today. That pitch runs up and in, and the count evens at one. It's 2-1. Rusty Greer on deck and Benji Gill in the hole. As if you joined us late, Texas with two in the first. Sox came right back with two in the bottom of the second. I said two in the second. And then Texas with one in the third. Sox is one in the third. Sox took that 5-3 lead with two in the fourth. Texas has tied it up here in the top of the fifth as that slow curveball goes around the plate. And the count 3-1. Robin cannot make the play. Ball not hit hard off the end of the bat. Meanwhile, McLemore will score. And the Rangers lead it 6-5.
Well, Voigt did not go the opposite way the way he was supposed to, but it's still worked out for him. Ball was hit off the end of the bat as he's pulling, and Robin looked like he may have just started his dive a little bit early. Now he just kind of mistimed that ball. So the Rangers take the lead 6-5.
Here's Rusty Greer. He's 2-for-2 with a run scored and two knocked in. Looks at it low and inside. Now Phil playing him to the right, but there is a huge gap in left center. Ball strike. 21 to count. Checks it up on that pitch. Durham going back. He's there. Makes the catch. So with one out here in the top of the fifth inning, let's pause for a station identification.
This is America's number one sports station, WGN-TV, Chicago.
Along with Tom Petroik, this is Ken Harrelson from Comiskey Park, where it is a chilly, damp, dank day here in Chicago. Here's Benji Gill. Benji 0-for-2. Hitting 289 as he stands in. Third ball strike catches the outside corner. Well, we talked about it earlier. Chances are this is going to be a high-scoring ball game. And so far, 11 runs through 4.5 innings.
Well, that happens when you don't have to swing until you want to.
One and one the count. So the book is done on Wilson Alvarez. 4+ innings, 6 runs earned, 8 hits, 4 walks, 2 strikeouts. Pitch runs outside, and the count moves to 2-1. That big curveball sweeping outside. So Benji Gill in good shape at 3-1. In game two, as we mentioned, it'll be Alex Fernandez against Roger Pavlik. Also, if you joined us late, John Kruk in the lineup. He's 0-1. He's walked twice, scored a run, and he was robbed of extra bases last inning on a nice play by Jack Voigt. That's ball four. So men at first and second, one out, and that'll bring up the leadoff hitter Otis Nixon. He's flied to center, he's flied to right, and he's grounded to second. Otis looks at a ball. No other activity for the Sox down in the pen. But there is some activity in the Ranger pen. Took a little something off that pitch. Had Nixon out in front. Fouls it back to even the count at one. Drizzle starting to get a little harder. Pitch up and in. So 2-1. Nichting and Burrows. Nichting.
Chris is that right-hander.
Chris Nichting.
I say with Nichting. Yeah, let's go with that. Like Seasting. Remember the old basketball player?
No. I was in diapers then. That pitch out of play. 2-2 the count.
Well, I remember him.
Here's a 2-2 pitch. Splitter. Boy, all these pitchers out there throwing a lot. Gross, Alvarez, De Leon throwing a lot of pitches to each and every hitter. There go the runners. And there's a ground ball right side. Durham up with it. Shovels it over to Big Frank. They force Nixon. And that's out number two. Here's Jeff Fry. He's 1-for-3. RBI single in the second. So this is a big out for the Sox right here. Texas on top, scoring three here in the top of the fifth inning to take that 6-5 lead. Curveball misses. The 1-0. There's a strike. And a reminder, our next game coming your way over WGN will be, poof, there it is, Friday night, starting at 5:30 with a dugout show hosted by Rich King. And then the game at 6, that's next Friday. Sox at Detroit. Right here on WGN. Pitch a little high, I guess, and the count 2-1. There's a strike outside corner. So the runners, Voight at third, Gillett second. And the 2-2 pitch to Jeff Fry. Hard hit, Robin, one hopper. Boy, that ball was smoked. Goes over to Big Frank, and that'll do it, but not before Texas comes up with three. On three hits, they leave two halfway home, 6-5 Rangers. Texas here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Rangers with three runs in the top. Just one home run by Texas in the game. Yvonne Rodriguez, two-run shot. One home run for the Sox. Tim Raines, the solo shot in the third, his fifth of the year. As the big right-hander Kevin Gross concluding his warm-up tosses. It'll be Ventura, Devereaux, and Durrell. Come on, Robin. Robin, 1-for-2. Sharp single to right in the second. He also scored. So the outfield swing slightly to the right. As that hard drizzle last inning now easing up just a shade. Just a little mist falling. That pitch high off the plate. Curveball high and the count 2-0. So Ventura in good shape. Well, I'll tell you, this field is absolutely remarkable. Roger Bossert and his crew. This thing is like a sponge.
Yeah, it's amazing. You can't hardly tell from by looking at the outfield that there were heavy rains all last night, this morning.
Here's the 3-0. Gets that fastball over. Fouls that pitch back. So a full count to Ventura. Wimpy, Monday, not a Seven Bridges, not Hawk Open. Did you have any memorable shots? That you created or did not create?
Oh, I didn't dial a shot, no. And I told all the guys afterwards, of course, that they beat me. It wasn't that big of a deal.
Robin goes down. So that is the first strikeout for Kevin Gross.
See, I don't think so. I don't think I had any memorable ones. No, they were all. Oh, yeah, the one. I thought I had the sandwich in my hand and the wind blew up and I decided, well, I better hit this harder, and I sculled it, hit a pee right at the cameraman over the green, just missed him. That's my memorable moment.
Devereaux pops it up right side. Jeff Fry. And that's out number two. And coming up after this half inning, you'll have your chance to win the ultimate power trip. WGN and Powerade are giving away two trips for two to the 1996 Summer Olympic Games. That'll be in Atlanta, just south of Stone Mountain.
Whoa.
So to enter, just keep watching, because at the end of this inning, we'll air a contest announcement, which you'll see a picture of myself and the Duke competing in two different Olympic events. Yes. Write down on the postcard the two events we're competing in. Then send in your answer, and if we pick your entry, you'll be going to Atlanta in 96.
Cool.
So keep watching, and good luck from Powerade, the official sports drink of the Olympic Games and WGN TV.
We're competing in events, huh?
I'd love it. Durham takes it down low. 2-0 the count. Durham takes a strike. Durham twice has gone out to Jeff Fry at second, one time knocking in a run. Fouls that fastball back, and the count evens at two.
Are we eligible to win?
Well, I would hope so, since they got us in the spot.
I never knew about this.
I didn't either.
Do they have permission to use our likeness?
Which one?
That's all right with me.
That's inside, 3-2. So a full count to Durham with two out here in the bottom of the fifth. Souvenir left side. Yeah, the rain's starting to fall a little harder.
Yeah. I think that window's closing in.
Yep. Yep. That's what appears to be happening. Once again, the payoff. This time he pops it up into left center field. Otis Nixon, the veteran, he's there, makes the catch. And Kevin Gross, a 1-2-3 inning. It is official, his first game after five. Texas by one. All the good folks at Southwest Airlines, tail of the tape, tell us that the Rangers are on top 6-5 with Mickey Tettleton leading it off here in the top of the sixth. Tettleton, Palmer, and Rodriguez to face Jose De Leon. Flips that curveball over, and the count, nothing and one. Tettleton's been to the plate three times. Walked in the first and second, struck out in the fourth. Pitch sailed high. And it's 1-1. So we mentioned another American League action. We'll show tonight Minnesota, Detroit, Milwaukee at Cleveland, Kansas City at Toronto, Orioles take on the Athletics at the Coliseum, Boston at Seattle, and New York against the Angels in California. There's a splitter. Misses and the count 2-1. Over in the National League, Cubs take on the Rockies at Coors Stadium, San Diego at Montreal, the Giants against the Phillies at Veterans Stadium. Houston at Cincinnati, the Fighting Fish against the Pirates in Pittsburgh, Dodgers at New York, and Atlanta takes on the Cardinals of St. Louis as Ozzy is there. And that's out number one. That'll bring up the third baseman, Dean Palmer. He has single, struck out, walked, and scored. Outfield playing him to hook. Fastball outside. It is getting nippier. Curveball, yes, he did, and the count evens at one. Tries to nip it outside corner, misses. It's not real nippy up there.
The Great Pouponers.
At the Stadium Club. That pitch high. Nip the outside corner, says Jim Joyce. Six, 9-1 for the Rangers, 5-6-0 for the good guys. It's a full count to Dean Palmer. And a payoff pitch. That ball hit high and deep in the left center field. Lance Johnson back at the fence. He jumps. Does he make the catch? He does not. You can put it on the board. Solo homer for Dean Palmer. And it's 7-5 Texas. For Palmer, that's his sixth home run and his 18th knocked in.
It looked like he just missed this one, but Dean Palmer is so short and quick. Well, he must have had some tremendous underspin on it. Rangers now lead 7-5. Say, he has really improved his swing. I tell you, he used to be a strikeout threat. Right there, that ball tailing in, didn't quite catch it all, but his head, very minimal head movement from Dean Palmer. We have seen in this ball game, Lance with a great effort just out of his reach.
Ivan Rodriguez fakes the bunt, takes the ball. He's 2-for-3, a single and a two-run shot. That was last inning. 2-0 fastball from Alvarez, and he heard it. Fouls that pitch back.
You know, they've got a real good hitting coach over here now, Rudy Jaramillo, who was in the Ranger organization, and then when Art Howe got the job at Houston, went with the Astros as the hitting coach. But he's always been highly regarded by the Rangers, and they brought him back. It looks like he's done a lot of good work shortening up these swings.
Curveball. And the count 1-2. That is the, as we mentioned, the sixth homer for Palmer. That's the fourth homer that De Leon has thrown this year. Activity down in the Sox pen. Southpaw Tim Fortuno. Outfield straight up as he drops down with that curveball, and he's gone. So two out, and a reminder, all kids 14 and under attending the Sunday, June 4th Sox game against the Tigers will receive Wimpy's favorite, a Waldo the White Sox Wolf action cap, courtesy of all the good folks at Coca-Cola. And that game time is 1:05, and tickets are available by dialing 312-831-1SOX. Wimpy will have his Waldo the White Sox Wolf action cap on that day.
Darn right.
Bet you, sweet Bippy.
I don't know if they come that large.
What are you running now?
Nice.
About 7 3/4?
3/8. That's all. It's your average bucket.
It is a gourd. No question. Mark McLemore, all he's doing is hitting at 404 as he stands in. He's 2-for-3 today, a single, a double, and he scored a pair. Go along with a stolen base. And a count 1-2. Two balls, two strikes.
A glove breaker inner.
No, pull a string splitter. He's gone. Dean Palmer, sixth homer after 5.5. 7-5 Rangers.
Dean Palmer put the Rangers ahead by 2 last inning with that solo homer to left center off Jose De Leon. Rangers, 7 runs, 10 hits, and an error. Sox with 5-6-0. And a new pitcher for Texas, 26-year-old left-hander Terry Burrows. 6 foot, 185 pounder from Lake Charles, Louisiana, is on the mound. 1-0 with a 4.63 ERA in 10 appearances. He has saved one, given up 14 hits in 11 and two-thirds. One walk, four strikeouts. His last outing was Saturday against the Brew Crew. Two-thirds of an inning, gave up two hits. So the left-hander, in relief of Kevin Gross, who has a chance to win this ball game and improve his record to 2-3. Kevin struggled, but last inning had a perfect 1-2-3 frame. Here's Noberto Martin to bat. Takes a fastball strike. Paco hitting for Michael Vollier. Bottom of the sixth, 7-5 Rangers. Rangers, as we mentioned, a lot of changes. Bob Tewksbury was added. Kevin Gross, there's a changeup strike. Swings right through it. Mickey Tettleton, Mark McLemore, Johnny Oates, the new skipper, new coaching staff. Rangers won the American League West last year, but they were 10 games under the 500 mark. That fastball misses away. Otis Nixon, a newcomer on their team, adding speed to the top of the lineup and defense in center field. Here's what they've added. Jeff Russell. Forgot about Jeff. And Bob Tewksbury, Tettleton, Nixon, and Gross. So they went out and got themselves some players who have really helped this team. Change up. You got him. Burrow strikes out his first hitter. Watch a changeup. He's got it back in his hand. He just kind of turns it over. Paco way out in front of it. Fish were biting there. One out. Here's Ozzie Guillen. Ozzie lined to the second baseman, doubled and scored his last time up. So Ozzie off to a great start on the season, hitting at 328. Driven in nine. Fastball, Ozzie hits it to the air center field, deep. Nixon on his horse, back to the warning track, and he flags it down. Ozzie gave that one a ride, but the ever-present Otis Nixon in center field pulls it in, two up, two down. So with one down, Lance Johnson, who has an RBI single, a stolen base, and a run score to his credit this afternoon. Lance hitting at 242. Tim Raines is on deck. Terry Burrows in relief of Kevin Gross. See the rain falling here at Comiskey Park. That pitch is high. Playing conditions are still very good. Rain would just hold off for a while. And that we have no control over. There's the check swing, little fly ball. McLemore can't get it. Foul ground. So Lance will come back and have a 1-1 pitch looking at him. National League tonight. Cubs are at Colorado, San Diego at Montreal. Giants against the Fighting Phils at Veterans Stadium. The Stros against the Redlegs. Fighting Fish at the Buccos. Bums at Metropolitan. Bravos against the Birds. The Redbirds, that is. There's a ball down low, 2-1. This is a cliche-filled world, isn't it? There's a shot to left field. So Lance Johnson gets a two-out single. He hammers it into left field, so he's 2-for-4.
Boy, those Phillies, 18-6.
How about that?
Three and a half games in front of the Bravos, five in front of Montreal. 8.5 in front of the Mets. Now the Fish having a tough time, 6-19.
Whew. Well, they are scuffling. Nick Bosman out to the mound. Little conversation with his pitcher, Terry Burrows. Johnny Oates on the horn. Yeah, we'll see what happens here as Jim Joyce Chris Niesting. Still warming up for the Rangers in the pen. Meeting ended. I doubt that Burroughs would be facing Frank Thomas if he gets up this inning. If Frank represents the lead run, which he'd have to if Timmy reaches. Rock one for three with that solo homer in the third inning. He has five long ones, 18 driven in on the season. Fastball misses down low. 1-0 on Rock. Outfield deep, straight away for Raines. Jim hitting at 310 as he stands in. Lance with a stolen base already in this game has eight. Check swing fouls that one back. Sox will have tomorrow off, we hope. Three-game series against the Tigers in Detroit. And then a four-game set Monday through Thursday against the very tough Cleveland Indians. Tribe on top of the American League Central. 1-1 pitch. Curveball.
Ouch.
Off that front foot. And we will have the game Friday on WGN with a pregame show at 5:30. Game starts at 6. Tuesday, we'll be at Cleveland for 6 o'clock p.m. start. And then on the first at Cleveland, and the fourth against the Tigers here at Comiskey. Dugout shows on the fourth, and then on Friday. There's a happy camper. What a better way to spend your afternoon.
Boy, Rock trying to walk it off. It got him evidently hard.
Now, well, looks like he's okay now. Well, he homered from both sides of the plate. You can see last year at Yankee Stadium. Excuse me, that was 2 years ago. That was 93. Here we go, the 1-2 from Burroughs. Fastball popped up out of play. And the Coca-Cola Silver and Black Pack is the official fan club of the White Sox for kids ages 16 and under. Club members receive free White Sox tickets, baseball card binder, an invitation to a baseball clinic, and much more. Stop by your local Sport Mart, the official outlet of the Coca-Cola Silver and Black Pack, to become a member. One, two to Raines. Raines starting to fall a little harder. He turns that changeup over. 2-2.
Oh, man.
Runner goes. Wow. Boy, Lance had that one standing up. Yeah.
Good day to play too, Duke.
Oh, perfect. He misses outside, 3-2.
So you were a good mutter, huh?
Not bad.
You loved it. Why did you love to play in the rain and in the mud?
Well, probably because it was the only time I used to get a chance to play because nobody else wanted to.
Did you munch up at the plate?
Yeah, pretty good.
You're awesome.
I didn't mind playing in the rain.
You were the total and the complete package.
There you go.
Look at this.
Get up to left center field. McLemore back. Like he's got room on the track, and he pulls it in. Rock just got it a little bit off the end. Sox threaten to come up empty. We've completed six from Comiskey Park. Rangers lead at 7-5.
Well, here at Comiskey Park, we already have six innings in. 7-5 Texas. For the Rangers, it'll be the lower third of their order. Voit, Greer, and Gill to face Jose De Leon. As you look at Ron Karkovice moved in behind the plate for Spanky LaValliere. So as you see, of course, on television, it always looks like it's raining harder, but it is coming down. It is a slight rain, not a drizzle or a mist. 1-0 the count to Voit. He's walked, flied to left, and knocked in a run with a double back in the fifth inning. 7-10-1 for Texas, 5-7-0 for the Sox. Curveball strike, says Jim Joyce. Vic Voltaggio at first, Dale Ford at second, Jim McKean, the crew chief, he's the umpire at third. Boy, jammed himself right there, pops it up. Ventura, right at the mound, one down. So here comes Rusty Greer. He's 2-for-3. A couple of singles, a run scored, a couple knocked in. Greer now with 15 RBIs on the year, hitting at 259 as he stands in. Outfield playing him to pull slightly. Breaking pitch strike. Set outside. If it gets that far, it'll be Alex against Pavlik in game two. But right now, that no looker too good.
You're right, it's no look too good. It's supposed to be a lot worse before it gets any better.
That ball smoked into the gap in left center field. Tim Raines on his horse will not get there. One hop off the top of the fence. So Rusty Greer with his third hit of the game.
Every time we've seen this young man up at the plate, he has been taking great swings and just knocking the daylights out of the ball. See right there, his hands stay back. Look at his head right there on contact. As he just smokes this ball into the gap. Man. Three hits in this ball game, a couple of RBIs.
That'll bring up the shortstop, Benji Gill. Benji 0-for-2 with a walk. Bunted into a 1-5 fielder's choice in the second. And he fouled out to Big Frank in the third. Curveball. That's upstairs. So Gill on top, 2-0. He joined us late. Rangers with 2 in the 2nd, 1 in the 3rd, 3 in the 5th, 1 in the 6th. Sox with 2 in the 2nd, 1 in the 3rd, 2 in the 4th to take that 5-3 lead before the Rangers put 4 on the board. There's a strike and a count, 2-1. activity down in the Sox pen is Rob Dibble. Pretty good heater upstairs. Gill could not get on top. And it's 2-2. In case you're looking to the Sox seventh, it'll be Frank Thomas, John Kruk, and Robin Ventura. He joined us late. Chris Sabo was designated for a reassignment as they put Kruk on the list. Slow curve. There's the crew chief. He is all snug. Looks like you, Duke, you know. Looks like you a little bit.
It looks like he's having a great time.
It does, you know, just like I said, like you. Nothing's ever wrong.
Nah.
Everything's right. You can live with those double and triples.
Double and triple what?
Bogeys.
Oh, I don't have a shot.
Curveball. Pull a string on that one. Had to go way out in front. So that is strikeout number three for De Leon. Nice pitch.
Yes, it was. Just enough. Double, almost triple clutching as Benji Gill. As that ball just seems like it never got to home plate. Now here's Otis Nixon. He's 0 for 4.
He sure is. Looks at splitter down low. Fly to left. Fly. Check that. Fly to center. Fly to right. Twice he's gone out to Ray Durham at second. That's hit into left field. Tim Raines. That's a fair ball. He's there. Makes a catch. And that'll retire the side. Nothing across. There was a one-out double by Rusty Greer. Seventh inning stretch from Comiskey Park. 7-5 bad guy. Right now, let's check out our Miller Lite Major League scoreboard. There you see. Milwaukee will take on Cleveland. Indians have won 7 out of the last 10. Brew Crew second in the American League Central. Minnesota against the Tigers. Twinkies having a tough time. 1-7 on the road. The Tigers 5-6 at home. Kansas City against the Jays at the Sky Dome. Royals in third place in the Central. And Toronto will leave having a tough go of it as well. Boston against Sweet Loose Mariners at the King Dome. Red Sox 7-3 on the road, and the Mariners lost 6 out of their last 10. Birds against the Athletics at the Coliseum. Yankees take on the Halos at the Big E in Anaheim. Yankees 5-5 on the road. Look at the Halos. Yeah, 1-5 straight. Boy, Chuck Finley last night was just outstanding. Over the National League, Cubs against the Rockies at Coors Stadium. Cubs having a very fine road trip. They're 6-2. Rockies 9-4 at home. San Diego at Montreal. San Francisco against Fregosi's Fighting Phillies. Houston at Cincinnati. Florida at Pittsburgh. Dodgers of Tommy Lasorda take on the Metropolitans in Shea. And the Atlanta Braves against the St. Louis Cardinals in St. Louis. Right here, Sox got some work to do. Not a whole bunch of time to do it in. It's the bottom of the seventh. 7-5 Texas. Here's a big hurt. He's 1-for-2 with an RBI single. Southpaw Terry Burrows delivers the off-speed pitch down low. It is now a soggy, soggy field that they are playing on as that pitch gets to the inside corner. To even the count at 1. Another strike. So Terry Burrows on top. 1-2. As our monitors are fading fast, going down one by one.
That's right.
Out in this rain. 1-2 pitch. There's that change. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Big Frank hitting at 304 as he stands in to go along with those five homers and 18 RBIs.
I think Burrow's best pitch is that changeup.
It's full count. Burrows with the payoff. That's up high, ball four. So the leadoff man aboard. And here comes the Kruckmeister, John Kruck. He walked and scored in the second. He walked in the third. And then in the fourth inning, he hit a P down the first baseline that Jack Voigt made a nice play on. Took away extra bases. Outfield swung way around to the left. Fastball strike. Boy playing behind Thomas at first. The pitch catches the outside corner, says Jim Joyce, and the count 0-2. Temperature continues to stay at that nippy mark.
Nothing like a cold rain.
No, I tell you. Just what a great day up. To play a doubleheader. There's darn a chopper. Right. It's foul. This is the day, Duke, that you just yearned for in your career, didn't you?
Yeah, I didn't mind.
Get out there. And
weather.
You had nothing else to do, did you?
No.
Just go out and play a little baseball, get a few hits, win a couple of games.
Yeah. Pretty much
then
it.
Go try to weasel some free food someplace after the game.
It's a great life, isn't it?
Oh boy, I'll tell you. Oh, and two. That's back as it takes Fry right to the bag, throw to first base just in time. So very quickly, two gone. That's the 33rd double play turn by the Rangers.
Well, you see, John gets this one a little bit on the end of the bat while really slowed up. Jeff Fry, he's a good-looking player. Real cool, calm. He's already made a couple of good defensive plays, a couple of solid hits. Four unassisted, three double play.
Here's Robin. One for three, a single, and a run scored back in the second. Takes that fastball strike. Boy, that's a lot of twin killings. 33.
Yeah. Ground ball double plays.
Well, they've got 33 altogether.
Yeah. Sox have only 18.
Altogether. There's a breaking ball strike to Ventura and a count 0-2.
So in other words, our guys haven't been getting the pitcher out of jams. Ergo.
Is that what your deductive reasoning is?
Yes, sir. I think it's pretty apparent.
So with a count 0-2 to Ventura, let's pause for our station identification.
This is America's number one sports station, WGN-TV, Chicago.
Along with that deductive reasoning devil, Tom Petrick. This is Ken Harrelson from Comiskey Park. First of a twin bill this afternoon. Right now, the Sox trail at 7-5 here with two out in the bottom of the seventh. One-two pitch. Wow. Terry Burr is just chunking right now. And after seven, he leads it 7-5. Roger Bossert, in between innings, talking with Jim McKean, the crew chief, as the rain continues to fall here at Comiskey Park. And Texas leads at 7-5 going to the top of the eighth inning in a pitching change, Wimpy.
Rob Dibble goes to work for the White Sox. Dibble this year, 0-1, working an inning and two-thirds, giving up two hits, three earned runs, and six walks. Ooh. Last outing, he lost the game against the Angels, giving up three runs in that inning. Dibble, first pitch, way inside to Jeff Fry. Fry 1-for-4 with a solid single, has an RBI. Two and oh. Rob missing all of last year with those arm problems, fires the fastball in there. Ooh. He underwent arthroscopic surgery on his right shoulder last April. Bunt popped up, foul right by the White Sox dugout. So 2-2 on Jeff Fry. It'll be Fry, Tettleton, and Dean Palmer to face Dibble here in the top of the ninth inning, and it's brightening up a little bit. Why'd I say that? The monsoon will be here in moments. Dibble once had 31 saves for the Cincinnati Reds. That was back in 1991. Whoa, got him on a breaking ball. Clark, the throw over to Frank Thomas. And there's one gone. So Dibble strikes out Fry to start the eighth inning. And all kids 14 and under attending the Wednesday, June 7th White Sox game against Toronto will receive a baseball card tin, compliments of Target. Game time 7:05, and tickets are available by calling 312-831-1SOX. So get your baseball card tin.
You want to run that by me again?
You going to get that? You want your tin? Can I have yours?
Well, certainly. Anything for you, Duke.
Mickey Tettleton, wow, that hurts.
Boy, it looked like a kneecap there for a second.
Dibble hits Tettleton. See where that got him. Thought it was on the ankle at first. Ooh, boy. That's smart.
It does.
I would think so. Rob Dibble's getting it up there over. Now, that one's behind Dean Palmer.
Wow.
Tettleton in the second on the wild pitch.
Now, this will get your attention. I'll
you
tell you.
You see my big fanny in the hanging in there.
Watch this.
Nah. I'd have been screaming right about there. Knowing it's going to kill you.
Oh, man.
Okay. 1-0 on Palmer. Ball's way up and in. 2-0. Oh, no thanks. I guess you can have this at bat.
He paints it black with three sliders.
If he does, so be
it.
That's
it. Grab some bench parts.
You're not going to see my big butt hanging in there. Strike on the inside corner, 2-1. Yvonne Rodriguez on deck. Tettleton in scoring position. Oh. Jam shot to short. Ozzie makes the play, two down.
Well, under the circumstances, that's a pretty good at bat right there for Dave Palmer.
I wouldn't have wanted any part
Not
of it.
Me either.
You're right. He hung in there. He just
did.
Got jammed.
I'm proud of him. He wasn't flinching.
No. There's a guy who might be flinching in a little while. Rodriguez, 2-for-4, has a two-run homer to his credit. Single, and he scored twice. So Yvonne has got that average up to 267. Fastball, he fouls it off to the right. Mark McLemore on deck. We're in the eighth inning. Rob Dibble, well, I'll tell you, if he can throw strikes. Oops, there's one up and away.
He well, his fastball is good enough. I mean, he's throwing the ball hard. And the other night when he came in, he got some sliders over that were very effective. But the big thing is that he's got to throw strikes to keep him away from being that one-pitch pitcher, because he's got to utilize that slider more now than he ever has.
Yeah. Rodriguez swings at a high fastball, so the count 1-2. And the one thing about Rob, too, is those fast guys get on base. He's got to not walk people, because those fast guys get on base, they're going to steal on him at will.
Fast guys?
Anybody, really. Mediocre guys, because he really drops that back shoulder, high leg kick. Good stop by Carr, keeping it in front of him.
Yeah, that slider. No, there have been a lot of pitchers throughout the course of baseball that had to live with that. They just got him out. They just got the hitter.
Nolan Ryan.
Seaver wasn't the greatest at holding guys
no.
on, you know.
Oh, no, he had that slow, deliberate. Never worried about it either. Oh, that's going to go to the screen. Here comes Tettleton. He'll score. Wild pitch. Rangers lead at 8-5. Oh, boy. I don't even know what that was. He certainly hung on to something too long.
That had to be the slider. He just hung on to it.
Whew. 3-2. He walked him. So a hit batsman and a walk. And a look to the White Sox bullpen has Scott Rudinsky warming up. Southpaw. Eight-five Rangers here in the top of the eighth inning. Jack Voigt on deck. Mark McLemore hasn't hurt his American League batting average, league-leading batting average. He's hitting at 400 as he stands in. 2-for-4 this afternoon. Takes a fastball away. Pours that one in there, strike at the knees. Mark was 20-for-25 in stolen bases last year for the O's. Frank Thomas playing behind Rodriguez. 2-1. Rangers with 11 hits against Sox pitching today. That misses outside, 3-1. Strike outside corner, 3-2. Sox have walked five today. Yeah, make that six. And Jackie Brown on his way out to the mound. Well, the walks have plagued the Sox all season long. Oakland has walked more people.
No, they haven't.
Yeah, they have. Well, we're tied with them now, 142. We'll check that. I'm looking at the wrong line. No, we're not. We're Texas has walked two more. And Toronto has walked 129. We came in at 112 to 118 now. And as you might guess, the Blue Jays are 13th in earned run average at 5.62. Wow. Oh, you walk them. And they usually score. And your ERA.
Another insight and nuance of the game of baseball.
Thank you.
Top Butchery.
You can just call me Mr. Baseball if you want. No, Euchre already is, so. Fastball inside. Jack Boyd, 1-for-3. Flied out twice, walked, doubled, and has an RBI. First and second, two out. Dibble, way inside.
Well, the guy you got to feel a little bad for right here is Karkovice.
Oh, yeah.
Much less the hitters. Because both of them, the hitters and Karkovice, are definitely on their tippy toes.
Yeah. I don't know. I wouldn't want to be one of those hitters, that's for sure. At least Kark's got all that padding on. He just doesn't know where the ball's going either. There's inside 3-0. Sox in the outfield playing Voigt to swing a little late.
They played him right.
Yeah. Ball four. Three walks in a row, and Gene Lamont on his way out to the mound. The Wascoe Wabbit, and that'll do it. So with the bases loaded, Scott Rudinsky is coming on the pitch, and we'll be back with his numbers right after this. Eight-five Rangers, bases loaded, two out here in the top of the eighth inning. And a new pitcher for the Sox is Scott Rudinsky. Brad, no record, 7-1-1 ERA, nine relief appearances. Giving up 10 hits and 6 1/3, three walks, two strikeouts. Last outing was Sunday against the Angels, going an inning and a third, and gave up no runs on two hits. And later tonight on WGN, get ready for 2 hours of laughs with the WB Wednesday Night Comedies. First at 7, it's a double run of the Wayans Brothers. Following at 8, Unhappily Ever After. And finally at 8:30, Muscle. The WD Comedies tonight at 7, right here on WGN Channel 9. Muscle, I like that. About, must be about bodybuilding. Rusty
Boy, that's
Greer.
You.
Greer fouls the first pitch off.
What, he was right on it, too. He
yes,
is really
he was.
Swinging the bat well.
Oh. He was struggling. He's been hot recently. There's a fastball up and in. One and one on Greer. They have a chance to break this thing wide open. Fastball up high. Greer now 9 for his last 16. The numbers against the Sox, 375 with 2 homers, 7 driven in, so he has really hurt us in his short career. Fastball inside, 3-1. Get the chills every once in a while here. Jam shot. Ray Durham makes the catch, and that'll do it. Whoa, Rangers come up with one and leave three. We have completed 7.5. Bad guys lead it 8-5.
Rangers by 3 here in the bottom of the 8th inning as the southpaw Terry Burrows taking his warm-up toss as he will face Devereaux, Durham, and Karkovice. And while we have a moment, as we were thanking Christine Makowski and Ed Farmer for their help, especially what a great job Christine Makowski did in running the golf tournament on Monday. We also want to send a big thank you to Catherine Brennan. I'll tell you, they work so hard to raise a whole bunch of money for the White Sox charities. So heartfelt thanks go out to everybody. As Ray, check that, Mike Devereaux will lead it off. He's 1-for-2. Mike singled in a run in the second inning. He walked in the third. He popped to second in the fifth, hitting .333 as he stands in. Takes the ball. There's a strike on the outside corner to even the count at one. It's 2-1. Well, the pitcher's record are the starters, Kevin Gross and Wilson Alvarez. There's a shot base hit in the center field. So Mike Devereaux, 2-for-3. More importantly, the lead man aboard. Just a second hit given up by Burrows.
Well, Mike got a fastball downstairs about knee high. Just drops a hit on it. See that leg kick? Mike is not a front foot hitter, as you can see. When his head stays still, he's been making some solid contact. He's been hot.
Here's Ray. Takes a fastball high. Durham twice has bounced out to Jeff Fry at second. Knocked in a run in the second inning, and he also has fly to center field. 8-11-1 for Texas, 5-8-0 for the Sox. Here's a strike. Wimpy mentioned Sox will have that off day tomorrow before leaving Thursday to go out to Detroit. It'll be a 3-game set and then a big 4-game series with the Cleveland Indians. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday before returning home for 3 more with the Tigers and 3 with the Blue Jays. Just a decent lead by Devereaux as a 2-1 pitch. It's 3-1. Good eye. Ball 4, base hit, Raymond. Let's get something going here in the bottom of the 8th. Now feel straight up. They're spread out. That's ball 4 and the first 2 men aboard. Yes. Second walk issued by Terry Burrows. Here comes the pitching coach, Dick Bosman. There's a Wimpy. Wimpy's getting these pigeons coming in right at him. That pigeon scared you.
I can't believe he didn't deposit anything on my head.
I'll tell you what, it's a good thing he had just done it.
That's the kind of luck. I remember Lasorda telling the story about he and Drysdale and Koufax are walking down the street in Montreal and a flock of pigeons fly by and they deposit it right in the middle of the crowd, hits Lasorda, misses the other two. Well, you'd figure to miss Drysdale and Koufax. Tommy says, that's an omen.
I'm going to use it as a good luck charm. I'm going to win 8 games in a row. He did. He went out and won 8 in a row. He lost his 9th start. He went out looking for a flock of pigeons.
All right, Sox with something cooking here in the 8th as Karkovy stands in, making his first plate appearance. 8-5 Texas. Devereaux at second and Durham at first. Burrows hits the outside half with that pitch and the count nothing in one. Fouls that one straight back. So Kark, as we talked about earlier, boy, he's been struggling at the plate. When you're struggling, first thing you look up at that scoreboard. And what's the count, Duke?
0-2. I know that one.
When you're going good, you look up at that scoreboard, and what would be the count, Duke?
2-0, 3-1. Pigeons are coming around again. Alfred Hitchcock's not around, is he?
Checks it up. Ozzie on deck. Tommy Lasorda. Boy, he taught you well.
He did. Well, that's a minor league story, you know, Montreal, because Tommy never won a big league game. Whoa, man. That's a good changeup right there. See, Kark's having trouble keeping his hands back. We talk about, especially on off-speed pitches, he's bringing them forward right from the get-go. Watch those hands. See, the hands are coming forward. Everything out in front. Side angle will show that. Nothing left to hit with.
Nah, it becomes a push then. Here's Ozzie. Ozzie's 1-for-3. He doubled and scored in the 4th. Then he faced Burrows in the 6th. Hit the ball hard to deep center field. Taking Otis Nixon back to the track. Jumped on first ball fastball last time. And there's the off-speed pitch this time. Ozzie hitting .323 as he stands in. As you look at the Sox runner, Devereaux at second and Durham at first. Mouthfield shading Ozzie to left. There's a ground ball. Fly right between his wickets. Here comes Devereaux. He will score. And it's an 8-6 ball game. Jeff Fry, who has been playing flawless baseball against the Sox, just didn't get his skirt down.
You are correct, sir. They weren't going to turn two on this play, and I think Jeff Fry, as soon as he has to make a couple steps to his left, he was not going to get two, but he could have gotten that runner at second base. Well, you're right, Hawk. Just a little bit of concentration or a little bit of a rush to try and get that ball to second base. Sox gets a break, 8-6, and now Lance Johnson, the hitter, who is swinging the bat great, 2-for-4.
With an RBI, with a run scored, and with a stolen base. So with one out, the tying run's aboard. More importantly, though, that might be if Lance or Rock can get aboard, give the Big Hurt a chance to hit this inning.
Yeah, that'd be large.
Curveball. Just flipped it up there and a count 1-0.
Well, most managers lately, when the starter goes out, they've been bringing in a lefty to offset the left-handed bats in the White Sox lineup. John Oates did the same thing.
Ball hard hit by Benji Gill. Durham is Ozzie on his way to third. They got a shot at him. They do not get him. And Lance Johnson in the second. It's an 8-7 game. Yes! Wimpy's picked a click.
Hello. I'll tell you, that was a gutsy play by Ozzie, but it was a good risk because the ball is wet and it doesn't get to Macklemore very quickly. So when Mark picks it up, that ball is going to be very slippery and it's tough to make an accurate throw. Ozzie hustling all the way, and by the throw going in the third, very alertly, Lance Johnson winds up in scoring position as well. So the Sox have a chance to pull this thing out here in the eighth inning to then get themselves a base hit.
Well, it won't be off Terry Burrows because here comes Johnny Oates. He wants the other left-hander. All right, so a break in the action as the Sox have put two on the board here in the bottom of the eighth inning, one out, minute second, third, and we'll be back with the numbers on the new Ranger pitcher right after this.
There you see it, 8-7, Rangers are trying to hang on. Sox have two runners in scoring position, though. Lance Johnson and Ozzie Guillen, they have put two on the board here in the bottom of the eighth inning, and a new pitcher is Ed Vosburgh. Ed, 34 years old, 6'1", 190-pounder, from Tucson, Arizona, in 8 2/3, giving up 6 hits, 2 walks, 7 strikeouts. So he has been effective last outing. Saturday against the Brew Crew, working 2/3, had a strikeout and a walk. So here comes Rock. Tim Raines with Frank Thomas on deck.
Ooh, that sounds nice.
Yeah.
8 runs, 11 hits, 2 errors. For the Rangers, 7 runs, 9 hits, no errors for the good guys. So Ed Vosburgh, the third Ranger pitcher of the afternoon.
Well, we'll see how the Rangers play this. If they're going to give up the run, they should be
back.
Back, yeah. Palmer's even with the bag at third. And Voit even with the bag at first. Middle infielders are back. Well, now Benji Gills goes all the way back.
So here we go. The tying run at third. First Navazzi with one down, and Rain steps in. He is 1-for-4. Solo shot. His fifth home of the year, back in the third inning. And you see 2-for-2 career versus Ed Vosburgh. So he's not in uncharted waters.
No. Last year he was with Oakland. Vosburgh was. 0-2 with a 3.95 earned run average in 16 appearances.
Here we go. Outfield straight up. Curveball strike. The 0-1 pitch. Misses low, and the count evens at 1. So the Rangers are now field of Mark McLemore in left, Modus Nixon in center, Rusty Greer in right. Palmer at third, Gill at short, Fry at second, Voit at first, and Vosburgh's 1-1 pitch. That ball hit hard off the glove of Dean Palmer. Ozzie's going to score. Range is safe. Sox have tied it up at 8. Yes!
Well, there's just a shot off the bat of Tim Raines. Dean Palmer tried to make the play to his left. Ball just hit too hard. He was in on the grass. You can see the carom. And that should be a base hit.
It is. So here comes Big Frank. Rock with those two RBIs now has 19 on the year. Frank 1-for-2. He's fly to center, walked, single, knocked in a run. And then he walked again in the seventh. And they're going to put him on and load him up.
I'll tell you, that's respect. Yep, they're going to put the A runner at second base.
So Frank will pick up his 28th walk of the season. And this is the Sox 23rd game.
And as John Kruk walks to the plate, the patio area at Comiskey Park is available for pregame parties with the Bertucci boys. And luxurious diamond suites can also be reserved for single game rentals. For more information on his unique party ideas, call the White Sox sales department at 312-924-1000. And now let's get back to business.
Sox packed with Sox, one out. Johnson at third, Raines at second, Thomas at first. Here's John Kruk. Kruk 0 for 2, couple of walks. No activity down in that Ranger pen as the breaking ball hits the outside corner and the count nothing and one. It's that foul territory. It'll be out of play. And a count 0-2.
I wish McElmore would have been able to catch that. I think he'd have probably let it go, though, Hawk, in foul ground.
I would have been out there.
Oh, yeah.
0-2 count.
Lefty versus lefty matchup. And heck, you're not going to throw out Lance Johnson.
Let it go and roll the dice.
Oh, yeah.
Blasberg with a sign from Rodriguez. Now Kruk will back it down. As the 0-2 pitch lays off of it down low, a ball and two strikes with Ventura on deck.
Well, that pass ball wild pitch always comes into play right here. Good stop by Rodriguez. It looks like Vosper's best pitch has got to be his breaking ball. Bounce a couple more.
What are you, Vaughn? Vosburgh taking a whole bunch of time locking it up on the side.
The Ed Norton School of Pitching.
Here's the 1-2. Two balls, two strikes. Good eye. Kruckmeister.
From what we've seen, he's getting a good look at the pitch, at all the pitches today.
There are the runners. One dog at third. Rock at second. And a big hurt at first. Man.
Will you throw the ball, Norton?
Throw it sometime.
Jeez. One thing about baseball, you can't go into a four corners.
Now Phil swung way around to the left. Boy, there is some room in right fields. Now Rodriguez and Vosburgh. Vaughn saying, what's going on out here?
See, Yvonne's putting the signs down in Spanish and Vosburgh's reading them in English.
Another nuance brought to you by the Whip-a-Roo.
Now they're set. Now they're on the same channel.
Here's a big pitch right here for Vosburgh.
Big.
It's a full count, thank you.
Ooh, that's a good job laying off that pitch. I know there's a couple guys in this booth that probably be sitting down right now.
On the way to grabbing some bench.
Well, this is large right here.
Well, if indeed his best pitch is a breaking ball, he got to stay with it.
Yeah, if he threw it on 2-2, you'd have to think he'd come with it again.
The payoff. He does, breaking pitch, and that'll be a souvenir left side.
Catch it. Yeah, that was a hanger right there, but Kruk is just, John's just trying to stay closed as long as possible.
That was just a get-me-over breaking ball right there.
Yeah.
Usually those have a tendency on 3-2 to go a long way. He's only had 16 at-bats prior to today.
That's amazing.
It is.
In 9 months, 10 months, actually.
Eight-eight tie here in the eighth inning. That's ball four. Sox lead at 9-8. Good eye, John Kruk. So here's Robin. Robin 1-for-4, a second inning single, and he has scored a run. Still one out. A pitch inside.
Boy, it's amazing.
Well, working that slow is hard to keep any kind of a rhythm and throw strikes.
Oh, yeah. Well, we have seen that throughout the league, though, this year. I mean, four-hour games are common.
Hey. 2-0. Get it right where you want it, 23. Or just let it go. There you see Robin.
Whoa.
Five salamis. Rosberg wants Rodriguez out to the mound.
You know, I always felt like if the pitcher didn't know what the signs were, how in the heck was that runner going to give them to the hitter? Second base.
You just put it right in proper perspective, Duke.
I did.
If the pitcher doesn't know what the signs were, how are you supposed to guess along with him?
Yeah.
Is a hitter.
That's right. Don't expect any help from that runner at second.
So that was my problem, huh? That pitch down and in. 2-1 to count. A 9-8 Sox lead. They have scored four here in the bottom of the eighth inning if you just joined us. Breaking ball. So a 2-2 count. Got activity down in the Ranger pen. Lays off of it. So it's 3-2 to Ventura. Roger McDowell.
Ah, old teammate of mine with the Metropolitans.
Not too many guys over the age of 35 that you hadn't played with.
Oh, yeah. Well, Roger's been around.
The payoff. That ball looped out in the left field. That going foul. Some points.
Nancy Faust with her rendition of the Chicken Dance. Famous from Detroit. You clucked along with that a few times.
Didn't I? All right. Now he has a sign, and once again, the payoff. That ball hit hard into left center field. McLemore racing over, makes the catch.
Oh, my.
As Raines will score, and the Sox lead at 10-8. Boy, there's a nice play by Mark McLemore.
Well, he showed you that good speed right there in getting to the gap. Field is very soggy right now as Robin smokes this one. Pitch down and in. He does an inside out number on that swing, dropping ahead of the bat. Gives it a long ride. Look at that's already over McLemore's head. He just reaches back and makes the catch. Rain scores easily. Sox put another run on the board, but it could have been a lot worse for the Rangers. Five runs in this inning for the good guys.
Good at bat off the left-hander by Ventura. Robin now with 15 knocked in. So it'll be Roger McDowell coming on. The pitch to Mike Devereaux. And a reminder, our next game coming away right here over WGN will be Friday night. Dugout Show starting at 5:30, hosted by Rich King. Then the game at 6, our next telecast against the Tigers next Friday, or this Friday, I should say, right here with WGN.
Numbers on Roger McDowell, no record with a 6.75 ERA, appearing in his 12th ball game. He's given up 11 hits and 13 and a third. That's not bad, but the walks are very high for McDowell. 10 with 8 strikeouts. He's a sinker slider type pitcher, got good movement on the fastball. His last outing, Friday, no decision versus the Brewers, 4 2/3, had a good one. 2 hits, no runs, 2 walks, and a couple of strikeouts.
Boy, the National League, when that sinker of his was working, he was devastating.
Oh,
boy,
yeah.
The bottom just fell right out of
yeah.
him.
And you think I can eat? You ought to see this guy.
Don't even insinuate that he can eat as much as you can.
Oh, yeah. He used to eat 2 double cheeseburgers before every game with the Mets, before he went out to the bullpen. God knows what he had when he went out, got out there. Yeah.
That was very reminiscent of your White Sox memory this
yes,
morning.
Yes, it was. Very similar. I don't think guys do that stuff anymore. Order out.
He's talking with Jiggins and North this morning, giving them his White Sox memory. Did they have the music going on, too?
Oh, yeah. Tears. They had their tears going.
And the Booter boy ate all the pizza.
Booter boy. In the end, Booter got it all.
What a White Sox memory that is.
Oh, terrific. They'll probably replay it a few hundred times.
That'll bring up Devereaux. He started this whole thing off earlier with that sharp single to center field. He's 2 for 3. He has knocked in a run. He has scored. So the 10th man to come to the plate. Thomas at second. And John Kruk at first. Devereaux now hitting at 343.
Wow, that's good.
Sinker strike, 10 runs, 10 hits, no errors for the Sox, 8 runs, 11 hits, and 2 errors for Texas. In case you're looking to the Ranger ninth, the scheduled hitters are Benji Gill, Otis Nixon, and Jeff Fry.
Well, there's nothing going on in the Sox bullpen. I don't know if Roberto Hernandez has been warming or he's done.
1 and 1 the count to Devereaux.
Certainly would expect Roberto to be in this ball game.
Breaking ball, cues it, nudges it right side. So it's a ball and two strikes. Oh, what a nice game this would be to wrap up first of this doubleheader this afternoon. Sox scuffling. It's 2-4 on this homestand.
Yeah, remember we talked about the time that, well, this is the end of the 14 of a 17 game span, where, which would be at home, and the Sox coming in.
We didn't make
7-8. Made no hay.
The 1-2. A lot of deuces on that board. Bella Brucker will be teeing up with the Tribe not too long from now.
Right. Twinkies against the Bengals. Bluebirds against the Blue Bloods.
2-2 pitch. Got him on the outside corner, so McDowell comes in. Strikes out Devereaux, and that'll do it, but not before the Sox come up with five big runs on just three hits. Check that, four hits, one huge error, two left, and after eight, they lead it 10-8. Southwest Airlines, tail of the tape. Sox with five big runs in the bottom of the eighth, lead it 10-8. And a pitching change. It'll be in place of Scott Rudinsky, Roberto Hernandez.
Roberto trying to wrap this thing up. 0-1 on the year with a 2.70 earned run average. So he's done a nice job with five saves and nine appearances. Giving up just eight hits in 10 innings, two walks. Good control. He's been striking them out, firing that fastball. 14 punch outs. Last outing Thursday, he saved the game against the A's, working an inning, gave up two hits, one Ernie, and he had a strikeout.
Is Benji Gill. Looks at the off-speed pitch low and away. Gill 0 for 3 this afternoon. Bunted into a fielder's choice. Popped to first, walked, and struck out. Outfield playing him slightly to the right. That fastball upstairs and the count 2-0. Otis Nixon on deck and Jeff Fry in the hole. Gill hitting at 286 as he stands in, takes a fastball right there, and it's 2-1. Boy, it is really cleared up nicely.
Yeah.
Starting to come out a little bit. Your
Why?
Kind of day, Duke.
What happened to Tom Skilling's prediction?
Another heater, and a count 2-2.
The skill man, the skillaroomba. What happened to him?
He's going over his notes.
Hey, come on out to the ballpark.
Yeah.
Plenty of baseball.
Got another
Get a
game
good
left.
Seat.
Up high, full count. Payoff. Pretty good hack. So the 22-year-old Ranger shortstop with a 3-2 count. He joined us late. Texas with 2 in the 2nd, 1 in the 3rd, 3 in the 5th, 1 in the 6th, 1 in the 8th. Sox with 2 in the 2nd, 1 in the 3rd, 2 in the 4th, 5 in the 8th. Got a piece of Jim Joyce, home plate umpire. Once again, the payoff. He's gone. Big out here in the top of the ninth inning.
That sure was. He just burns this one right by him on 3-2. Hit this if you can. Baltai right down the middle. Benji Gill can't catch up with it. And the all-important first out in the ninth.
So the pitchers of record are Scott Rudinsky and Terry Burrows.
Now Burrows was cruising along there pretty good for just over two innings. Boy, that error was really big last inning.
Huge error.
Jeff Fry had a great game going for himself, swinging the bat and making some fine defensive plays. And believe it or not, the sun's out.
See? RBIs for the Sox, two by Lance Johnson, who has three hits this afternoon. Two by Tim Raines with a homer and an RBI single. One by the Big Hurt to go along with three walks. One by John Kruk, one by Ventura, one by Devereaux, and one by Ray Durrell. So here's Nixon. Tries to bunt it over the head of Ventura. Robin was in on the grass. Otis has drawn the collar in five at-bats. Fly to center, fly to right. Twice he has bounced to Durham, and he has flied to left.
That's good. You got to keep this guy off the base paths.
That fastball. High and wide in the count one and one.
Infield hits. Those are guys can fly.
Two balls and a strike.
I didn't know we kept track of infield hits.
Well, they're keeping track.
Jeez. The heck, you know how many infield hits you get.
What, you're hitting on day games after 4:30?
Yeah. Uh-oh.
It's 3-1. Got to come back and get him, Roberto. It's a full count.
I still can't understand the trend in baseball today.
Just forget about it. That's the way it is.
That's the way it's going to be.
That's the way it's going to be for a while.
Walt Alston used to make me take when I walked out, got to the plate. And maybe I'll let you swing when you got two strikes on you.
Full count to Nixon. Chops that one away. Well, I have seen a guy before he left the dugout, the manager told him to take three.
And who might that guy be?
I'm trying to think of the pitcher's name.
Hank Aguirre.
No, I think it was Dave Wickersham.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
He wasn't a real good hitter.
Told him to take three.
Sit out. Oh.
That's low ball four, so you didn't want to do that. Because that'll bring that tying run to the plate. And here comes Jeff Fry, and you know he's just itching to atone for that large error he made last inning. He's 1-for-5, a second inning RBI single. Takes a fastball strike right down 35th and Shields.
Is that nine walks the Sox have issued? It might count right.
You're right on the money, as usual.
I was hoping I was wrong. Well, I'll tell you.
Outfield around to the right, gap in left center. Yes, he did, says Vic Valtaggio, and the count nothing in two. Short lead by Nixon. He's gone. Held on to by Karkovic. And that's out number two.
High heat right here. Jeff Fry goes fishing. Well, that's almost helmet high, and he just got a piece, but Kark right there to make the catch on the foul tip. Here's a tough man to get out, though, Mickey Tettleton.
The dangerous Mickey Tettleton. He's 0 for 2 this afternoon. He's walked twice, struck out, popped a short, and he was hit by a pitch. Mickey with 6 homers, 17 knocked in. He's diving. Boy, you throw him some low fastball around the outside corner or 3 or 4 inches outside. That's his wheelhouse. Left-handed.
Was talking to Mickey about that just before the game.
Takes that one right down the heart. So what was his response? Just don't tell us you were talking to him.
No, he just laughed about it. He says, well, I can hit other pitches too. I says, yeah, but you kill that one.
There goes the runner. That ball shanked in the left field. That's going to be a base hit. So Raines takes it on the first bounce as Nixon will move into third. They were not holding Otis Nixon on.
Well, nobody said this was going to be easy. Man, well, nothing has been easy for the Sox so far this year.
Sean Hare, one of Wimpy's favorites at the end of run.
Hare, what a good name for a pinch runner. Should be fast.
Spring training, he was in left and Fox was in center.
The Fox and the Hare. Outfield.
Meanwhile, here is Dean Palmer. He's 2 for 4 with a homer. Takes a pitch inside. So the tying runs aboard with two out here in the top of the ninth inning. Off-speed pitch, he gets it over and the count evens at one. A ball, a strike, two out. You see he is 1 for 5. Lifetime, it did not stay in the yard. Short, quick swing on that fastball, and Roberto on top of ball and two strikes.
Yeah, Palmer really looks dangerous at the plate right now. He looks like he's in one of those good streaks, but you know, when you look at his strikeout to at bats ratio, he's way down, which is means somebody's done some quality work with him. He has a tendency to chase that breaking ball out of in the dirt. We'll see if what Hernandez throws here.
Two balls, two strikes, two out. Yes! Roberto Hernandez comes on, strikes out the side here in the top of the ninth inning to nail it down for Scott Rudinsky as the Sox put 5 on the board in the bottom of the 8th to come back from that 8-5 deficit. They win the first of this doubleheader. Our Miller Genuine Draft Light play of the game coming in the 8th inning. Lance Johnson at the plate. Wimpy.
Well, Lance had a great afternoon. 3 consecutive hits, and wow, he goes out there and gets this one off Terry Burrow by Benji Gill in the left field. Driving in another big run. Sox with a big 5-run 8th inning to take this one 10-8. That's big.
And let's check out the totals on the board for the first of this doubleheader this afternoon. For the good guys, 10 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They stranded 8. For the Rangers, 8 runs, 12 hits, 2 errors. They stranded 14 runners. The winner, Rudinsky, 1-0. Burroughs takes a loss, 1-1. Credit Roberto Hernandez with his 6th save of the season. And our next White Sox telecast over WGN will be Friday night from Tiger Stadium. When the Sox beat the Bengals in the first of a 3-game set, we'll begin with a dugout show at 5:30, followed by the Sox and Tigers at 6. Over my partner, the Wimperoo, Tom Pachurik, our producer-director, Skip Ellison, our associate producer, John Waller, and this is a Hawk, Ken Harrelson. So long, everybody.
Chicago White Sox baseball on WGN, brought to you by cold-filtered Miller Genuine Draft, making the world a very cool place. Your local Ford dealer. See 5 of the top 10 selling vehicles in America at your local Ford dealer. Coca-Cola, always a hit, always Coca-Cola. Aflac, insuring over 38 million people worldwide. Menards, helping you build America's heartland.
your Chicagoland Northwest Indiana Toyota dealers. I love what you do for me, Toyota. And by Southwest Airlines at convenient Midway Airport, the official airline of WGN-TV Sports. Fly Southwest, the low-fare airline.